God, if this doesn't fucking work and one of these motherfuckers can't hear me, I'm gonna start rioting! Hello? Hi, Zandy. Hi, Ollie. Hello? Hello? Are we back? I can hear. God fucking damn it. Ah! Hi. Hi, sorry. Everything I've ever owned is broken. I tried to announce the stream, and then it took 7 years to download the game, and then apparently stream started twice, or maybe three times. At this point, I'm not sure. And then also my mic doesn't work. Why? Because the world hates me, and I am God's goofiest fucking jester. The world is horrible, and I'm giving in. I'm giving in. This is my breaking point. Hello, everybody. My name is Almost Sander, and welcome home. Computers suck. Okay. I apologize for everything breaking. Yeah, multiple stream starts, my microphone not working, and the game taking 7 years to download, but we're here. It worked, I think. Hopefully you can see me, you can hear me, and the game isn't gonna blow anything up. Fingers crossed. I promise nothing, but fingers crossed that this shit works. Turn this fucking music down. It's so loud. All right, motherfuckers, we're playing a game today. Now let me give you a quick overrun about how this is gonna work. This was recommended on the Discord by a host of people who all chorously agreed that they want to see me play Indigo Park. Now, I had never heard of Indigo Park. I've not seen anybody play Indigo Park. I've not seen any clips of Indigo Park. I've never even seen a photo of Indigo Park. I just saw that it was free on stream and I immediately downloaded it, and it opened on my computer under a thing called raccoon.exe. So it can only be good. Love when things are labeled.exe. Brings me joy. So I'm sure it's something. And I've been told it is a mascot horror based off of the Steam account that I downloaded it from. So I'm assuming mascot horror on the lines of like Garden of Banban, like that kind of side of the world, Five Nights at Freddy's, not really, but like the same, like you go into place that has person and it is scary. Like, do you know what I mean? That's like one of those. That's like one of the, yeah, you know what I mean? So like, yeah, Rambly the Raccoon. Yeah, mascot horror. So like, you know, it's one of those, you go into a place and there's a specific character that everybody likes. And literally Rambly Trust. Okay, good. Those of you who have played this are gonna have to help me through this. I've been told it's not super long. Longer than the fucking Ban Ban shit or the other, whatever the long blue thing was. It's longer than that, but not like a full length game. So if this game is short, then we'll do other stuff on stream. And if it's long, I might just be bad at it. And chat is welcome to come help around here. You are welcome to give assistance. Don't like spoil anything for me, but backseat gaming is somewhat permitted in the case of if I don't know what I'm doing. If I have the capability of figuring it out, let me figure it out. But if you're like, Xander, quick, you're missing this really important thing. Yeah, do that. Do that for me. So yeah, that's about it. Is it better than Ban Ban? Good. It's not very long. You should keep an eye on your surroundings to see fun little things and go slow to hear all of the quirky voice lines. Understood. Spoiler, there's a Ranger Rick looking ass raccoon. I like that spoiler. All right. Get this music out of here. Why is my Discord flashing red? It's because I have notifications. That's new. I actually quite like that. That's cool that it does that for me now. Actually, wait, am I? Oh, I am not on streamer mode. That is why you were going to hear all of my Discord notifications. Please hold streamer mode on, please. Thank you. You're going to hear all of my annoying notifications. All I gotta say is that if you see fun or cool things, take them. You don't have to tell a kleptomaniac twice. Let's play this bullshit, hey? Welcome to Indigo Park. Can you guys hear this all right? Just gonna make sure you guys hear this, okay? And that it's not too loud or louder than me. It's a little loud for me, but I feel like it might be the right volume for you guys. tad bit loud. Okay. I have a very loud computer. So having it at a normal volume will be very, very loud for me. Okay. Is this a good volume for y'all? Does this sound okay? Sound better? I really like the twitchy looking bird thing that's chilling over there. Scoot your cam to the corner. I can do that. Ooh. My computer is immediately running warm. It is stressed about this. Pardon me for a moment. Put me up there. All right. Is that a good place for me up here? Hello. Hello down there. Is this an okay place for me? Hi, Dad. Bye, Dad. Gotta go. Hi, Rotten. Bye, Rotten. Have a good day. Corner dweller. I do dwell in the corner now. I live up here. I live, laugh, love up here. Is my computer's running really warm. Bro, it only runs warm like this for like fucking Subnautica. Jesus Christ. Computer, chill the fuck out, baby. I know I need to clean you, but Jesus. There's no way this thing runs like fucking Subnautica does, so. You're so small now. Yeah, I'm up here. Alright. Do you want me to be a little bigger? I can be a little larger. There. Alright. Let's see how this goes, bitches. Do I need to, like, turn my lights off? Is it supposed to be that kind of scary? Is this a lights off kind of game? Do we turn our lights off? I hate horror games. Alexa, light off. This'll work. All right. And then, all right. Welcome to the slight light adjustment. I'm in the dark now, so hopefully you can see me okay. Hopefully it's not too dark. Dad, I'm gay for my boyfriend. Bro, that's crazy. I'm also gay for your boyfriend. No. I'm also gay, but please enjoy your boyfriend. Props to you for gay, I guess. All right, lights off, let's play. New game, I suppose. All right. Hello, hello, raccoon. Ah, Isaac Indigo's.
For all who journey to this newfound paradise, we welcome you. Indigo Park offers a slice of the American dream to call your own.
Already uncanny.
Echoes of days gone are brought back to life as a new generation captures a glimpse of the exciting potential of tomorrow.
Uncanny.
Indigo Park pays homage to the values, dreams, and unwavering truths that gave rise to our great nation.
Right.
Here you embark on the journey of a lifetime, a place of creativity.
That's weird.
Where your dreams hold you.
That probably freaked out a lot of streamers, because I was like, for a second, I was like, is that my setup? Because it looks like it. Oh, funky. Ooh. We're going in. This music goes hard. This music fucks. Birds of a feather. All right. That's wild. That fucking speaker at the beginning was so uncanny valley because I could tell it's 3D animation. Holy shit, is that sensitive? Oh my god, hang on. Is there a mouse sensitivity thing? Holy shit. Hello? Yeah. Wait, no, that's... I guess that would be that. Controls, yeah, okay. Can I, like... That's ooh, it's still really bad, but okay, that's a little bit better. This I can control. Cause Christ. Jesus Christ. Okay. Wow. This is like gorgeous. There's a little bit of visual glitch. There's like a little bit of screen tearing. But it's not awful. For a free game, this looks gorgeous. There's that little bit of screen tear on it a little bit, but that happens. Wow. Huh. Oh, I might slow it down just a little bit more, because Jesus Christ. I'm just whipping my shit all over the place. I feel like I can manage this. Warning you right here and right now. Warning you right here and right now. I am not a horror person. Is that Montgomery Gator? Anyways, I'm not a horror person. I'm terrible at horror games. I love watching them. I hate playing them. You'll get lots of pauses while I freak out. I will scream. Deal with it. Now, is that or is Montgomery Gator? I can take Montgomery Gator? Wait, now I have to look for more things. Bro. Oh, I'm okay, so we now know I am thicker than that, which means I am thicker than a fucking Snicker, goddamn. Bro. Okay, I've got sprint. Never a good sign in a game. Alright. I can also turn my flashlight off. Hello? Any other things I can take here? No, but I can walk over it. I'm back here now. The fact that I can walk through these rocks tells me I am not supposed to be back here. Interesting. Okay. Interesting. Anything else? Ooh, hello. Visit an information kiosk to learn more. Are you an information kiosk? I guess not. That's fine. Are you an information kiosk? I guess not. Leloid. Nostalgia. Don't we all just live in nostalgia? All right, what's gonna eat me in here? I don't like that I can't crouch.
Hi there, yeah. And welcome to Indigo Park, the world's most innovative and engaging family fun experience.
Mm-hmm.
Jump into the world of your favorite character. Wait, you're our first guest in 2,920 days, 4 hours, 23 minutes, and 38 seconds.
Right.
Congratulations.
Thank you.
I'm rambling, Ridley the Raccoon.
Hi, buddy.
And it's my job to make sure your experience here at Indigo Park is the most fun it can be.
Sweet.
Hop on over to the registration center to your left, where our friendly assistant will help you begin your adventure in the park. Hi, I'm Rambly. Rambly the Raccoon. And it's my job to make sure your experience here at Indigo Park is registered. Let me just get a good look at you.
Get a look at me.
You don't seem to have your face in our guest list.
I see.
Is this your first time here at the park? Or did you just get plastic surgery?
Plastic surgery.
No worries.
Glad
it's
you noticed.
Rambly Tuesday.
Oh, thank you.
So you qualify for a big discount on your
visit. Fuck yeah.
Just follow me to the main gate.
All right.
Ooh, I can't wait for you to see everything Indigo Park has to offer.
All right, sounds good to me. You need to work on your cable management, Ramble. Can I call you Rambo? Interesting. He says Tuesday, the computer says Saturday. That's new to me. And yeah, well, he's probably lying. Rambo probably wants to eat my soul. All right, Rambo, you want me at the front gate? I'm on my way.
What's the holdup? The gate is open. Head on into the entryway. Hold on. My mistake. The gate is not open.
No, it's not, Rambo.
There seems to be an error message being sent from the gate's power unit. Lucky you!
Oh?
You get to be the first person to try our turn on the generator mini Rambly venture.
Right.
Have fun!
Yeah, this is not, that's not a game. You know what? All right. Follow the big auspicious power line. I'm sure the answer's over. I have to go back this way. I'm sure the answer's over here. I see. Don't tell me.
The Indigo Violet compact power generator.
Thanks.
To be inoperable. Looks like it's missing a piece. Can you find it?
Bitch, I don't want to find it. You just told me how to sprint. It's missing a piece. I'm not even sure what kind of piece it's... That feels like an obvious answer. Right. I'm gonna have to run now, aren't I?
Okay, for real this time. Welcome to Indigo Park!
Thank you. This place is awful. Press F to toggle. Am I gonna have to like hide from shit? Don't have to run yet? Okay. I like Lord the Lion. Okay. So I've gotten the Lloyd, the fucking Montgomery Gator, the Rambo, and I need the fucking Oscar the Ostrich looking ass. That camera follows you. That camera follows you. Right. I don't like Lloyd. Something about him rubs you the wrong way. We've got some really split decisions on Lloyd. I am going to sneeze. It's coming. It's coming and I can feel it. There's Carl the Cuckoo Bird. Wranglers only. He looks like the Gator from Five Nights at Freddy's. That's why I'm calling him Montgomery Gator. That's the Five Nights at Freddy's alligator.
Oh, silly Rambly. Every guest needs a critter cuff. That will allow you access to reserved areas, charge payments to your room, and wear a critter cuff. I think there's some in the gift shop.
Right.
Head in there and I'll get you set up.
Please have your critter cuff ready to scan. If you don't have a critter cuff, please visit the information desk of the critter co-op to get yourself registered. Yes, sir. Man, there's so many things I could steal. Who's this bitch? I like that one. Can I have this one? 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 I can't have any of these.
Here you go, buddy.
Oh.
Your very own critter cuff. A new way to interact with the park that also doubles as a pedometer, heart monitor, and mood ring. Data disclosure agreement included.
Right. That looks exactly like a Disney Fastpass. That is a Disney Fastpass. Great. I've got my Disney Fastpass on now. The moon is up there. None of these information kiosks have told me about my collectibles.
Uh-oh, the door mysteriously locked. Why not test out your band and save the day?
You just chose to lock me in here. That is actively something you chose to do. Right.
Hooray! Great work, buddy.
Thanks.
Now try entering the park and we can start our Indigo adventure.
Bro, put me on Space Mountain. Bro, let's go. Let's head in. Let's fuck up Space Mountain. Why are we fucking jacked? I don't know, man. I've been fucking pumping iron. I've been pumping Ripley Raccoons or whatever the fuck his name is. Oh, it doesn't spin. Oh, it does spin. A nice touch. That's a good touch. That's a good touch. Alright, who's Ronald the fucking Donald over here? Big open space is my favorite. Lloyd is one of the theater kids, but like one of the aggravating ones. I'm not saying aggravating, like neurodivergent, like actually annoying. Right. I know that's the guy from the opening speech. Okay, before I get my ass eaten in the tunnel, I'm gonna go blow my nose, because otherwise I'm gonna sneeze the fuck out of this place. Hang on. Thank you for your understanding, chat. Also, do you want to see something really quickly before we continue? I'm going to put something on. You're going to love it because we're in black lights right now, right? Just hold on. Hang on. This might be my new horror game outfit because you got to see this shit. This thing's crazy. If you've seen my TikTok, you know what I'm putting on. But this might be my new horror game fit. Bro. This shit go wild. Holy shit. This shit's crazy. Is this thing not fucking awesome? Like, it's so dope. This might be my new horror game outfit. Just cause like, when we're sitting in black lights, man, this thing looks so fucking cool. Anyways, I had to show it off because I was like, bro, brave type fit. Yeah, -10 on stealth. You can see me across the fucking room. I wore this to fucking State Fair and I was like, you don't have to worry about losing me because you will see me across every crowd. I'm not getting into Kobold Camp. I'm not getting into anything. Yeah, fuck it. My next D&D character is going to be a rogue who likes to go to raves. So they're like a rogue constantly covered in just fluorescence. Before you start the game again, who did you go see this weekend or last weekend? I saw, Avatar, Ice Nine Kills, In This Moment, and then the opener was TX2. Yes, that TX2. When I'm finished with the game, I will give you guys all the concert drama because there is a lot, like, a lot. This weekend had some of the most drama I've had in a very long time. So after the game, I will break you down all of the crazy shit that happened over the weekend, because holy shit. Anyways, back to the game. I'm just glowing in the corner now. I will take this off if I start sweating, because it is... I'll just put my fan on. Let me be smart. Ouch. Hopefully, you guys don't hear this and it's enough to keep me cool. Okay, that should be fine. Yes, Wicked did eat a kobold in her D&D campaign. Wicked decided that she wanted to win, and so she ate a kobold. Like a freak. Anyways, back to the video game. Of course she did. They are just actually people. No, they are. They are just actually people, and she's a freak. Oh, I'm gonna die now, right? Is this where I die? Right. Cool. So is this where I, like, declare my gender? There's some really bad screen tearing, like, right down the center of the screen. Oh, wait. It doesn't happen for you guys. I guess, of course, it doesn't capture it. It just is just on my side, because my game refreshes at the wrong rate. That doesn't help at all. Well, I'm putting it back unlocked. Oh. That does help. Okay, I'm not crazy. There's a skibbity rambly in the bathroom. Of course there is. Ron Paul Jr.? Hello? 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 Racist Ralph? You in here? Hello? Aha. I'm just gonna start saying two R words together and just make it whatever this dude's name is, Racist Ralph. All right.
Pardon our dust, buddy.
Hey.
Looks like the park is going through some renovations.
Right.
For the inconvenience, your Rambly Tuesday discount will be 3% off.
Oh.
Why not celebrate this great deal with a ride on my railroad? To test your sleuthing skills, I'll let you find this one all by yourself.
That's a queer. That is a queer. All right, Rochambeau. I'll listen to you. I'm gonna guess it is Rambly's Railroad, so, just head this way. I don't like this area. I don't like this area.
Facial data suggests you may be a bit older than the target audience for this ride, but it's one of my favorites. Do you know why Rambly the Raccoon loves Rambly's Railroad? Because I like trains.
And he's autistic. That's an autism raccoon. If I was doing two R words together and slurs were a thing that I could say. Finish the sentence. I know better. And I would never, but. Sorry, anyways. Alright, Ripley's Believe It or Not. Let me get on your train. Bonk. What in the Barbie Pink Funhouse? Let's go, dude. Choo-choo, motherfuckers. It's autism train time.
Welcome to Rambly's Railroad. I'm Conductor Rambly.
Right.
Oh, look! It's Molly McCaw!
It's Molly McCaw, the greatest pilot you've
I thought it was
McCaw.
Moaning McCaw.
You sure are, Mo. Why, you only crashed into 6 bars this week.
Oh, moaning.
Crashing, Rambly? I'm barnstorming!
Right.
What's barnstorming?
It's crashing with style.
Right. Thanks, Millie Molly.
Oh, Finley, come on out and greet the people.
I ran.
Oh!
Why the long face and body?
You've known me for 100 years, Rambly. I'm always long.
I love Finley.
Because I'm always longing for a new seashell for my collection.
I'm into Finley.
Oh, Finley. Should come out of your shell.
How about you come into it instead?
Yes, I will.
Oceanic Odyssey.
I'm on the way.
Will teach you all about the wonders down under the deep.
I will come into your shell.
It's as blue as me.
Yes, sir.
I hope you'll visit. I'm so lonely.
He's so lonely. No, it's closed, Finley. Okay, the ride shit itself. You're pretty. Emily would like her. She looks like she would be mean to her. What? Finley! Hat. Oh no, it's 2 gears this time. Oh. I'm gonna run. I'm not gonna look at anything because I'm afraid. I'm running. I'm on the train. Let me on. Oh, goodbye. Oh?
Do not shame me with that common folk name. I am the proud, the prestigious, the professional.
Emily will also like him.
Lion, actor extraordinaire.
You dumb man.
Great act, Lloyd.
Of course it was. I'm
right. Lacist Lloyd goes wild. Oh, well, the train's over. Let me out.
So, what do you think? Pretty fun, right?
Yeah, it was great.
I know all about my friends and Lloyd. So, where do you want to go?
There is something on the tracks. That's the bird, isn't it? That's the there's a bird running down the tracks at me, huh? Wow, that's pretty. I want to go to Ocean Odyssey and meet Finley. They said that Ocean Odyssey was closed for repairs, though, so we can't. Yeah, they've closed it specifically to keep me out. They specifically don't want me going. I think that's Ocean Odyssey. This is Lloyd's Theater, so I could head over there. Or... Lemonade Alice's Shake-Ups. Café de Ratan Levour. Oh, the clock doesn't know what time it is. How silly. We can go to the cafe.
Hey, buddy, come over here.
Yes, sir. How can I help you?
This here is an information key.
Oh, finally.
If there's anything around the park you want to ask me about, just stop by here and I'll ramble on about it. I got this. I know the commercial by heart.
Wow, it's the unlimited edition Bramley the Raccoon Ration Figure. Push him down and he jumps. Push him up and he doesn't. Only $19.99 at your favorite toy store.
Right. Cool. Molly Plush. I remember when my mom took us to the parks one summer. Her favorite was always Molly. So when they first opened the new Molly meet and greet in Jetstream Junction, it was some of the first in line. That is Finley. I understand now.
Oh, Molly Plush. She's always been my best friend. Did you know she builds planes in her landing pad at the park?
Huh.
And then she crashes them.
Yeah.
She's so talented.
Me about my best friends. Me about any of my best friends, anytime they do anything.
You found my buddy Finley. You know, he's really shy. Like, too shy. Like, obnoxiously shy. But he's got a good heart. I hope you get to meet him someday.
I hope so, too.
You, Floyd.
Right. Interesting.
Congratulations! You found me! Don't I look adorable?
Yeah.
Rambly ears? Those used to fly off the shelves. That pair is pretty damaged, though. Keep your eyes peeled. There's gotta be at least one more mint condition set out there somewhere. Like a yard sale!
Alright. So we start missing, like, what looks like two plushes, a set of what looks like even worse off Rambly ears, but it might be better ones, a very pixelated grapefruit, and a what looks like a margarita. Alright. Well, let's go to Lloyd's Theater. Might as well. Chat, feel free to warn me if there's a point where I'm going to have to be able to run, or if I'm supposed to start running. Feel free to warn me. That's permitted. All right, Lloyd. Well, running is until the end. Okay, cool. That takes some stress off of me. I guess we don't get to go see the drama show. Throw a brick through the window. I gotta get a brick first. I like that when I go to run, it just zooms. So I can just, like... Guess I'll go to the cafe. Try again, critter cuff. I was trying the critter cuff. Oh, that's the margarita. Those cookies have grown mold. Cookie? Bro, the prices here are fantastic. $3 coffee? Oh, I guess it is a $5 mocha, which is what I get. $8 frappuccino. Honestly, those prices are pretty accurate. Yeah, those cookies probably have sentience. All right, let's go learn about the margarita.
Ooh, that's a Rambly cup.
Yeah.
Nothing beats the taste of fresh Rambleberry juice drunk directly out of my plastic lifeless head.
Right. All right, we can't go in there. Let me see if there's anything else over here before I go down the rest of the way. Okay, my legs are too wide for that. Okay, I want to get all the collectibles. So if you guys know that I'm like actively missing something, or if I'm like stupid, or I'm like staring at it and missing it, let me know. But otherwise, I'm gonna do my best. All right. The nighttime noises are pretty great. Ah, hello. Golden Freddy? Let's go learn about Golden Freddy.
Edition gold Rambly plush? Parents were fighting tooth and nail for those things when they came out. Seriously, our employees had to clean up so many stray teeth and nails. Hard to believe there was all that demand for a regular Rambly plush we just blasted with gold spray paint.
Yeah, that sounds right. Let's go back to the theater, maybe they'll hold the critter cup up a bit longer. I promise I tried. I'm gonna have to, because you won't get much time during the react. There's a collectible during the run, it'll be on a shelf, okay. I'll go back and show you again, but I was doing the same thing to the critter cuff as I was doing everything else. This does not let me in. Probably because this is chapter one, and this chapter is Birds of a Feather, so this is supposed to be about Molly. We're not supposed to be able to get into Lloyd's stuff yet. But, yeah, we are not allowed in there yet. I'm guessing Lloyd will be chapter three or four, because it seems like it goes Molly, Finley, something mysterious, and then Lloyd. So.
Well, look at that. You're at Jetstream Junction.
I see.
Oops. Looks like Jetstream Junction's being tuned up. Last I checked, there's a security office in the back of the theater.
Right.
Maybe a friendly wrangler can help you get in.
Now I can get into the orange areas. Okay. So now I can go into Lloyd's. All right. You're getting your septum pierced? Dude, it's so fun. Here's my warning to you for septums, just so you're ready for it when you know it's happening. A, you're gonna sneeze. B, you're gonna cry, not out of pain, but just because, like, pinching your nose makes your eyes well up so much. And then also, they're gonna use a clamp, right? So they're gonna have, like, a plastic clamp that goes on the septum of your nose where they pierce it. The clamp that goes on your nose will hurt more than the actual piercing. So once the clamp is on, you're like, ow, that hurts. That's literally the worst pain you will feel the entire time. That clamp hurts worse than the needle does, I promise. It's so weird. But you'll do great. The septum piercings, so good, so sexy. My past roommate had it done twice because she had hers close up on accident. So it's so good, so good. Your piercer will be so good. All right, let's go, boys. Fucking Ralph the Lion time. Lick that Lloyd, I'm coming for you. Wow. Very pretty. I don't like you just being there, to be honest. Perfect. I sneeze a lot. My eyes are literally waterfalls. I have an okay pain tolerance, though. Yeah. The sneeze will catch you the first time he sticks the what do you call them? The graspers? The I just used the word. Clamp. Thank you. I stopped using my brain. He went away. Yeah, the when he first sticks the clamp up your nose, you're gonna sneeze. They're gonna warn you. They're gonna be like, it's okay if you sneeze, and you probably will. And then your eyes will water. That's just the life of you. But listen, I'm looking for collectibles.
Hey, buddy, I've got eyes all over the park, but I can't see anything behind the stage. If you're going back there, be careful. Your Kritikov is not yet able to resuscitate you.
What? Just noticing the vibe of the game. Is this horror? Will there be jump scares? Because I'm a tad wimpy and I can handle nothing. I'm going to be honest. Yes, this is a horror game. Yes, there are supposed to be jump scares. I've been told they're not super bad. And I'm just making jokes along the whole way, so don't stress too much, hopefully. But I'm also a tad wimpy when it comes to playing games, so don't worry. It's going to be okay. Just walk, sprint if you want to. All right. I'm being told to just go for it. I gotta make sure I'm not missing any collectibles. This shit bops. Cool, well, we've got music now. You've missed all of them so far, sadly, because one of them didn't load and the others were hard to see, but they're not important spooks, yeah. Honestly, the more jump scares I miss, the better. I feel like a mom walking her kids near something. You are a mom walking their kids near something scary. I need to stop being surprised when I experience the consequences of my actions. Yeah. Unfortunately, those do happen. God, I hate jump scares. Oh my God. Hello. Hey there, buddy. So, do I just pretend you're not there? Should I? Hey, reading with lions. Do I, You like a... Do I like a... Holy shit, he's so large. Don't make eye contact with Cat Sander. Me for real? Okay. No, Mossy the Mothman. Listen, it's me and you. It's me and you, okay? We're two pussies in a crowd full of cows, okay? We gotta handle this together. It's me and you. It's you and I. It's us together. That's just large racist Lloyd. Don't mind him. He's large and racist, but nothing else bad. Honestly, racism is probably the worst thing about him. He's not even really a killer. He's actually really a very sweet and gentle person. He raises orphans on the weekend, but he's just horribly, wildly racist. Admittedly, it's really his only downfall. It causes a lot of problems among the school children. Come on, kids, just keep walking. Surely nothing bad can happen here. This sucks. I admittedly don't want to be here. It's just me and racist Lloyd. Oh, classic racism. The claws are for being racist, yeah. Yeah, he's a Republican. He votes blue or red or whatever color is bad. Why does this stress me out so much? Don't you hear kitty. Don't you Trump supporter Lloyd me. I think there's a collectible in here. Fuck. Homophobic Lloyd, yeah. It can't hurt you. I feel like you're lying to me. You're a lying lion. You're a liar and you're lying and there's got to be a collectible somewhere. Oh my god, I can jump. Oh, I've got the hops of a toddler. I've just gained the use of my kneecaps. Why do I hop like a bitch? I've got all the verticality of a white man with scoliosis. No. Okay. Now what, bitch? Clearly this was not the run section. He died? I hope he died. Racism is bad. No chase? Okay. Listen. The run section is scarier, don't worry. I hate it here. I don't like horror games. Yeah, where the fuck did he go? Operating on predator instincts. You won't see him again? Okay, cool. I'm gonna be real, chat. You want me to play horror games? You're gonna have to walk me through it like a mom holding her kid's hand and giving me little smooches on the forehead the whole time and letting me sip on my goddamn coffee, because Xander loves horror movies and real life haunted house interactions and hates horror video games. And I don't know why. Now just give me the fucking collectible and let me go home. Guys, did I miss one? Was it betwixt Lloyd's cheeks? Did I miss the collectible? Ted, I'm scared. It's okay, he can't get you. He's no longer here to hurt you. Thank you, chat. Thank you for the smooches. Fuck. You should have ran him and grabbed it. No, shit. I didn't know I had to kiss him to get the collectible. I would have done it. He might be racist, but I'll still give him a kiss if it means I get the collectible. Pucker up, motherfucker. I'll give you a little... And then I get the collectible. I get some rip-off Mickey Mouse ears. My friend. It's really quite hot in here.
I beat you to it before you had me come in here.
Thanks. I got the key. Emily is now here to give me little smooches on the forehead, chat. Don't worry about it. I got it.
I'm here for moral support.
Why do I hear banging out there? Bitch. That is not ambient noises. They're like, ambient noises. That is the sound of somebody running. And it's getting closer.
It's giving Sunny Meadows.
Lacist is gone. He can't hurt you. That doesn't mean some other bitch ain't out here. Tyrion just said, ew, Sunny Meadows.
I said it.
What am I supposed to do about that? How do you want me to get back out of here if I can hear him? He's just mad he got bonked, it's fine. I can't tell if they're gaslighting me or not, unironically.
I don't know if Lloyd is dead. I've never played this game.
Tyrion, don't say nah. I'm being gaslit. Y'all are fake as fuck. Lloyd's alive. Fuck. Don't you say gaslighting for a good cause. I know the. I might. You can go through the area safely. Confidence. I'm whimpering. I'm whimpering like a man in bed should. Let Xander out. Let Xander out. Let Xander go home. Let Xander go home. He doesn't want to deal with Lloyd or any other racists. Let Xander go home. Ah, Lloyd! Why is every animatronic racist? You know, I'm not sure. Please let me go home now. Ah, the bird! Why is Slender Man the bird watching me? Why is he here? Why is it so hot in this room?
I'm like cold.
You're not sitting by the furnace that is my computer right now.
Under your desk.
Honestly, if you sat right underneath my desk right now, you'd be fucking baked like a chicken. I could boil water on my PC right now. It's running this bitch like it's fucking Subnautica.
I mean, it looks like it's pretty high def.
It's very high res, but there's no way. I mean, this game took forever to download. I don't know what engine they're running this thing on, but it's ridiculous.
Game Boy Advance.
Did you say Game Boy Advance?
Yes, man, I did.
My favorite game, run on the Game Boy Advance.
What's this game called?
I don't remember.
What's this game called?
Indigo Park.
Indigo Park on my 3DS.
On my on my Game Boy Color.
Guys, I'm streaming on the DSi today.
Is anybody else in this chat old enough to remember getting a Game Boy Color and being absolutely blown away that it had color?
Unfortunately, man, no one else had a Game Boy Color besides you, my brother.
I fucking loved
my game console was in fact a DSi.
Mine was a Game Boy Advanced before they had the Game Boy Color.
That's really great, man. A Diaz.
And then it was the GameCube. No, I got my Atari from my grandfather. I had and played an Atari. That thing was dope. I played the original Pong.
The only Atari I know is the character from Public Burglaria named Akari, I think her name is.
Wild. Can we please put that in the quotes? What quote?
Put in the quotes.
Put what in the quote?
Pulling up Indigo Park on my DSi?
Yeah. Playing Indigo Park on my... Is my flashlight off? Why is my flashlight off?
I didn't know you had a flashlight.
So, like, can I just leave now? The Game Boy Color thing. The pulling up Indigo Park on my Game Boy Color? Or, no, brother, I'm sorry. You are the only person who had a Game Boy Color. I am on my way. Let me the fuck out of here. Time to go fly? Woohoo! Let's go. Let's go play with Mommy Molly and get out of here. Interior wants to put in mod codes.
Like every other game, there's a token woman.
Yeah.
One woman.
Why is it every game?
Every game has one woman.
It's every game, yeah. Every movie, every book series.
They're always a white woman.
It's the five-man band, and one of them is the heart, and the heart is the woman.
The white woman.
It's always either the heart or the stupid one.
Or sometimes they're the brains, but then they're, like, portrayed as annoying.
Yeah. Or they're the brawn, and they're specifically played as either not feminine at all or really feminine.
That one's really niche, though. I think that's, like, I don't see that.
Weirdly enough, you see it a lot in animes.
I don't see that.
I see it a lot in animes where it's the five-man band and the woman is the woman.
Might just be thinking of Erza.
No, there's a couple animes I could pull up that are the one person is that it's a woman is the super strong one, specifically the super strong one who's super feminine and is like, yes, I wear lipstick, but I could also beat your ass because I'm a woman. I'm specifically thinking of Seven Deadly Sins right now, but there's a couple others I swear I could pull up. What is that bitch's name in Seven Deadly Sins?
Simply not the brawn in that movie.
Who?
Someone said Hercules Ref. No.
Meg is not the...
Meg is not the brawn.
In Hercules, no, Meg is not the brawn. In
Hercules is the brain.
Honey, I'm Hercules. I fucking love the movie. Can we watch Hercules again?
We already did.
I said again. Did I miss the collectible?
If you want a group of lesbians with a dumb straight man you adopted, I got a show for you.
I got a show for you. Seriously, go watch She-Ra Princess of Power. I played the one dumb straight man.
Lesbians and then Ball and Seahawk.
I played the only straight man in that show. And don't say Bo.
Bo's bi, at least.
Exactly.
I did the glimmer.
If you do like She-Ra, Princess of Power, Serena cosplayed She-Ra and I cosplayed the token straight dumb bitch.
That I did.
Seahawk can't be that straight. Seahawk is specifically straight.
He
loves one man, one man. He loves one woman and one woman only, and that is Mermista. He is wickedly straight in the best himbo way ever. Straight men can be good if they're Seahawk.
Yeah, that man doesn't got an ounce of queerness in his body.
Not an ounce. He's so straight. And we love him for it. Can somebody tell me if I missed a fucking collectible? Because I'm going to be a pissy little bitch baby if I did. I'm going to be a pissy little whiny little bitch baby if I did. But we love Seahawk. We do. We can love a straight man. It's okay. You don't have to hate them. All right. Ring-a-ding-a-ding, let's go fly a plane. Come on, Amelia Bedelia. Anybody else? Amelia Bedelia, you get that reference?
Say, why don't you check out Molly's rooftop races?
Why'd you think I was here?
And it's a great warm-up before we get into the bigger rides. just taken up at Molly's landing pad.
Yes, sir. Who forgot to texture this soda machine? Chat,
sorry, that was me.
Hey, brother, you forgot to texture this vending machine.
I left soda machine number 7 over in fucking Bedelia's area.
Why is it completely untextured? That's the texture not found, like.
I want the magenta and black.
That's funny as hell.
That one's out of service.
Oh, well, shit. All right, never mind. I forget when things go out of service, they just lose their texture.
Like, oh, hey, we ran out of the 7-Up, and then, like, the...
it, like, blinks out of existence. That machine is so me-core. Yeah, my gender is just texture not found.
My gender is textureless soda machine.
Real. All right, Amelia Bedelia, let's do this shit.
I fear her name's not that.
It's not. It's Mommy Molly or whatever the fuck.
I don't think her name is Mommy.
It's something like that.
She looks like Amelia Earhart.
Yeah, that's why I was making the Amelia Bedelia joke.
Oh.
Because I was going to say Amelia Earhart, but that's the obvious answer, so I was saying Amelia Bedelia. I think that joke's a little old, though, because I think Amelia Bedelia was, like, ended showing when I was a kid.
Yeah, man, I don't want to tell
you. Amelia Bedelia was this fucking hilarious,
I know what she was in concept, but I didn't watch the show.
Do you?
Like, I've heard of her.
Have you seen, like, the books?
No. I've seen the covers, but I didn't read them. Like, I know of her. I read, like, Junie B. Jones.
Junie B. Jones
was
fine.
That was more my era.
I had the Junie B. Jones, what is it? Junie B. Jones, My Personal Beeswax.
I read all of them. I was her number one fan.
I was not. What is this? Did I click on the wrong thing? Sans Undertale? Oh. Ah. Oh. Wow, I'm probably the worst gamer. I am the silly, silly little raccoon. Fuck me, this is actually really hard. It's not, but it's just like it moves so quick. Oh, this is gonna be so annoying. Oh, I can land on their heads. Okay. Oh my god, dude, it just flies! Jesus Christ. Oh my god, there's fucking no control. This is awful. Oh my god, stop with the text. Stop with the text, please. I can double jump, right? I'm gonna need... It's gonna be the collectible. Did I miss any over there? I don't think so. You cunt waffle in my tits. Oh, that's gay. Alright guys, lock in. This is the next 7 hours of the game. This is the next rest of the game. I'm gonna put peanut butter in my anus. This sucks.
Don't do that.
I don't know what else to do. Yes, yeah. When I get upset, I go full Thanksgiving.
You're getting stuffed like a fucking
Thanksgiving. Okay. Oh, cunt, tits. Yeah, except these controls suck. Okay, the hardest part seems to be right at the beginning, though, so it's okay. Oh, those two are in love. That's gay. Okay. The platforming is a little confusing, but okay, we're working on it. Like, because the three-dimensional textures make it a little hard to see. Oh, it's Molly. I swear to God, if I missed one raspberry, I have 39. Okay, Rimbly, I was going through the woods, but suddenly I couldn't see a thing. Hello, whoever you are. Salem! Looks like my smokescreen made a crash right on target. Salem, I should have known you were behind this. You shady skunk, let her go. Nah. I was about to try a new potion on her instead. I'm tired of wasting on squirrels. Molly, look out! What the fuck? Why is Molly now purple? What the fuck did you do to Molly? Why is she tweaking? Too slow, dumpster face. What did you do to her? Meet the new and improved Molly McCaw. Now, with none of the friendship garbage stopping her from tearing you to pieces. Oh, Molly McCaw's about to eat my ass. I wonder if she really thinks of you now. Have fun finding out. Oh my God, no, Emily didn't get your muffin. I still have your muffin. I never gave it to her.
What?
I completely forgot.
My muffin.
I will get that to you now. I will get that to you after stream.
It's just been in the car.
Yeah, for real, for real.
I'll go get it.
The muffins are fucking awesome.
I'll go get it right now. It's in the glove box.
No, it's in the back seat. I can't. This sucks. Oh, I'm gonna die. Oh my God, did I live? I totally forgot, I apologize. I saved one for myself and one for Emily. I got it. I got the fucking collectible.
I need your keys.
They're on the floor right there.
Why are they on the floor?
You know, I haven't picked them up in several days, admittedly.
No, you can't. Oh.
All right, well, Missy's in here now. Hey, Missy. Do you want to say hi to the class really quick? Madame LeFou. Come here. Come here. Oh, shoot. You'd have to say hi to her. I had to let you say hello. She does. She has so much to say. She has so many opinions so often. Right, madam? It's not just when she's upset about being picked up. She's very opinionated. She is a big, beautiful fluff ball. Right, baby? Oh, yeah. Big, beautiful girl. That's our old lady. She's like 13, I think. So she's our big lady. Love her. I support her. Campaign for president. Yeah, for sure, for sure. She's pretty great. Right, madam? She's under my chair now. Favorite political candidate? She would win. All right. Please do not steal my cat. It's always an option. Welcome back. Yeah, I forgot about those. Alright, let me...
Sorry, I derailed your stream.
Ollie made muffins, like, a week ago?
Don't worry, let me get a spotlight on these.
Oh god, they've, like, melted.
Nice.
Give me a spotlight.
There you go.
They don't look like they've gone
bad. They're so warm.
They're so warm. They've melted.
They're so warm.
But they haven't gone bad. But they have melted in the heat.
If it tastes like absolute shit, it's not my fault.
Let me tell you how it tastes. It has completely melted in the heat. It's so hot. And kind of bad. It's not nearly as good as when you made it. It's been in the car for weeks. It tastes hot.
For weeks.
It's not... It's not physically hot, but it tastes
fresh
hot.
Out of the oven.
It's pretty awful.
Give me a second to see it.
The aftertaste is good, and then it's bad. Steamed.
They're not bad, but they are very wet.
Steamed muffins
it's not
is
even that they're
awful.
Warm, they're just wet. Because yeah. they've been humidifying in the backseat.
Pretty awful. Ollie,
they're
my
not
deep
bad, though.
My deepest apologies.
They're good. I'm gonna let them chill.
I ate two of them
and eat it later.
At her house, because they were awesome. And then I forgot about them.
I can tell that they're supposed to be really good.
They were absolutely awesome.
And they aren't bad. Like the taste is good. I'm just gonna let it aerate a little bit. And like honestly, I might let it stale a little bit just so it's not as fucking soggy.
It is really wet. Maybe let it aerate not in my room.
Maybe.
I'm going to have it aerate somewhere that isn't here.
Did I drop some on the ground?
Can we please have some? Yeah. Mushrooms for chat? Muffins for chat. No mushrooms for you, though. Yeah, those are boiled muffins.
Just like our chicken, we white people boil our muffins.
Veracious says to toss them in the fridge and then toast them in the oven to undo the left in the car texture.
That can't be the solution. How that follow? He wants in, but he's afraid to breach the threshold. Come here, sir. No, don't run from me. No.
He's gone.
He ran from me.
All right. It is so warm in here. I held Missy up for the chat.
I'm surprised you picked her up.
I'm not afraid of her. I'm just afraid
of... A lot of people are.
I'm not. I'm just afraid of upsetting her.
Oh, she's fine.
I'd rather her not dislike me. Out of the 12 muffins I make, I eat one and gave the rest away. I am a giver. Actually, I ate two.
I am a giver.
Oh, hydrate? I can do that. Girl, we blanchin'. No, we do not live up in a mansion. Alright, let's play this shit. Back to fucking birdcore or whatever we're doing over here. Bird hop the sock rock or whatever the fuck. Anything over here? No? All the soda machines got their textures. Salem's canonically non-binary. That's pretty dope. I like a non-binary skunk. Of course, that just makes sense. Alright, doesn't seem to be anything revolutionary up here. Just space. Where are the stairs? They're this way. They're also in the ace colors. Love that. I fear purple, black, and like the purple, black, gray, white is a pretty common color collection because like it's just the grayscale and then the color purple. Like that's a fairly common collection of colors. So I fear many characters are accidentally in the ace spectrum when they don't mean to be, but I'm gonna take the representation anyways. Yeah, it is like the best color spectrum you could possibly have. It's literally just grayscale and purple. Anything good over here? Fuck yeah! Poodle! I got me a poodle. Xander, scary part is coming soon, time soon, just so you know. I'm guessing it's gonna be the game, right? I'm gonna go in and it's gonna
get dominated.
Oh.
Blur.
Blur. Thank you, Reese. No, wait! You resubscribe. I guess you're one of the people who said you're not waiting to resubscribe for the thing because you're not losing your streak or whatever it is. I think you were one of the people who was like, no, I am not waiting to redo my sub. If you're not one of those people, here's my quick plug. Quick, if you're going to resub, don't do it now. Hold your tits together for just 2 more weeks. Or 1 more week? Yeah. How long? What day is it?
It's a week from now.
Holy shit, it's a week from...
A week in 1 day!
Today's Wednesday, isn't it?
Yeah.
Am I doing Wednesday or Thursday?
I thought you were doing Thursday.
I thought I was doing Wednesday.
I thought you were doing Thursday.
I'll double check. Thought I did. Was, I might have been doing Thursday.
You're gonna be working Wednesday.
Yeah, but I normally start after. It's either Wednesday or Thursday. I'm gonna double check what I put on my schedule.
Sunday, you might want to do Thursday.
I'm gonna be live on Thursday because I said so. So, hold your subs, hold your bits, hold your tits, hold my tits if that's okay with you. But yeah, that's the thing that the subathon is coming up in a week and a day. My quick little plug for that, if you're going to be there, subscribing gains time to the thing or adds time to my timer. Donating bits adds time to the timer. Buying me any game on my Steam wishlist adds time to your timer.
Buy Xander Wobbly Life.
Buy me Wobbly Life. It'll be on my list this week. Buy it during the subathon though to add time to the timer. Equivalent to its dollar amount. Donating actual dollar TTS, the text to speech, all of those will be text to speech or whatever. Those add time to the timer. Buying me anything off of my throne wishlist adds time to the timer. Buying any of the merch off of the Streamlabs adds time to the timer. If there is any reason or any way that the money ends up getting to me in any form, time gets added to the timer. But yeah. Oh no, is Emily addicted to Wobbly Life now? No, we were just.
I just like the game.
It just seems fun, and Emily seems to like it, and I would like to get to play it because all of my other friends have apparently. So I would like to play. So, yeah. Anyways, back to this game. Wobbly Life was there in my darkest hour.
Oh no, this is horrible. Looks like Molly crashed into the right again. Don't worry though, your pal Rambly has the repairman on speed dial.
Seems right.
We're sorry. The number you have dialed has been disconnected or is no longer in service.
Yeah.
Please check the number and dial again.
Say, why don't you check out Molly's landing pad? It's not far from here, and it's a great cooldown after that exhilarating ride. Just take a down from Molly's rooftop races.
Right. Yeah, repair guy's definitely dead. Bro, this place sucks. Playpen time? Alright, hopefully that means fun things and not scary things. Oh! Right! Okay. Hello? Right. This is so loud. Hang on, I'm turning. Oh. I'm gonna turn this down just slightly because it is deafening. Just the music in this room. Jesus Christ. What were you saying, Xander? You should play Still Wakes the Deep. You would hate it a lot. Don't play it. You might cry. I promise most horror games that are like actual. Okay, I don't want to say actual. Like classic fighter horror games like Dead Space and shit don't bother me much at all. And honestly, I've played a lot of horror games that were scarier than this in a non this setting. Like, when I'm playing on my PlayStation, very few games have ever bothered me. It's when I'm in a dark room with a screen 5 inches from my face and a camera on me that, for some reason, scares me a lot more. This game is based on an oil rig in the middle of the ocean on a storm. That's one of those things that I think logically should scare me, but I'm not sure it would as much as it should. Specifically because, like, I have megalophobia and I have thalassophobia. But I think it's more that I have, like, submechanophobia. That, like, if we fell into the water at any point and I'm looking up at the oil rig, that would probably freak me out. But, like, being on the oil rig and looking down, I don't think would freak me out as much. I probably would still have a bad time with it. But. I see. Right. Okay, hang on. I have to use my brain, apparently. I like that the rust texture stays still while this spins. Like, look at the rust texture. The rust texture is just on the flat of it. That's very funny. Molly's landing pad. Tashcon ball pit, yeah. Chase soon, fear doors, but it's gonna be okay. Okay, okay, thank you, thank you, thank you. Be a tad uneasy in this area. Understood, understood. Thank you, chat. Reese, I did give them permission for this because I don't want to be here. They forced me into playing this game. All right, I feel a little bit stupid right now. Piss your pants like a real man? Nah, not interested, but thank you. I don't have answers. I feel like you have something to do with this. Star, maybe pink is star? Like, pink is star? No, thank you. I am not interested in this. Don't say sensory time.
I am so confused. I cannot hear the audio.
I got a puzzle right, and then the lights turned off, and there was a noise, and now I'm uninterested. They are calling me kiddo, and also the chat now cannot decide if it's pink, purple, or magenta.
Purple.
It's honestly probably magenta, but it's quite pink. Listen. Fuck you guys. That is simply too quiet. I definitely made it too quiet. I did not want that.
You are now blind.
I'm deaf?
No. I know what I said.
Damn right, Queen. Stick to it.
Period.
I don't want to be here, chat. Ah! No! 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 Nope, no, 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 tits in my tater tots. I don't wanna play this shot. What the fuck am I supposed to do about that, huh? Am I supposed to keep going? You just want me to follow the bird? You want me to follow the bird? Throw it back to distract it. Deal. All right. I don't know which way is forward and backwards now. I'm lost.
It failed critically.
It hurt itself in its confusion. If I turn my flashlight off and I just can't see, it can't scare me.
Yeah, that's what you should do. No audio, no visuals.
Yeah, no audio, no video. If I take my headphones out and I turn the flashlight off.
Just walk forward.
Yeah, I'm just holding the forward button right now. This is better, right? This is better. Chat, how's this experience for you? Honestly, this experience is pretty great for me. Helen Keller playthrough goes crazy. That's so fucked.
Disengages
Faz. That's what I do when I get scared in Faz. Yeah, when it's 1 a.m. No, genuinely. Crouch in a hiding spot. Take your headphones off. No, genuinely. I like how because my screen is on, if I'm facing the blue, like, it's like you can see my face. Like, look at my camera. You can see my face, and then I turn to the red. And I am just the color red now. That's wild. Now it looks like the police are after me. Anyways. Yeah, you gotta clock out mid-round. Look forward, yellow O. Oh. Get it? Yellow. Oh. Oh, okay. Spaghetti is. So.
We also have spaghetti.
Go on. I give up. Spaghetti is so.
Spaghetti-os.
Spaghetti.
We had spaghetti today.
Please don't murder me. I lived. Yellow. Right. She's a lesbian. She can't be sidetracked by your manly ass. So real. I do not like sauce, and I have a vendetta against round vowels. So does that apply just to O, or is like A and U also like a little too rounded for you? An E. I mean, E is almost no. You're really only like I's and Y's. The token girl of the group being a lesbian feels unfair to her. Honestly, it feels right. So what's the goal here? Is that a trampoline? Do I jump and pray I get to the other side? Oh, yep, red star. Oh! I just die. I just die instantaneously. Okay. Oh, okay. Gonna try that again. I'm gonna hip, a hop, a hip, a hibbity. Okay, I made it. So there's gonna be a bird in this tube again, right? Because there's consistently birds in my anus. Okay, so red star. Remember that, Jabberinos. Why is my homie no round? True. All right, I'm gonna turn off my flashlight, and I'm gonna do this Helen Keller style again. And there's gonna be a bird in here. All right, Helen Keller bird, you don't scare me. You don't scare me. Show me your feathery tits, or maybe don't show me your feathery tits. I'm actually really not sure if I'm into that. I'm like almost certain I'm not. Okay, red is star, which I already have. That's perfect. So I just need green and blue. Have you gotten a colonoscopy recently? Have there been any avians? Don't jump. Understood. I won't jump off of the ledge. Ah, it looks like green is triangular. All right, cool. Triangular green. Flashlight on, please. All right, fine. Listen, I'm playing Helen Keller, okay? Is that fucked up to say? I can't tell.
A little bit.
All right. Oh, ow. Well, okay, so I'm really inefficient at bouncing. This is not a safe play place for children. You cannot have trampolines that just launch them into other floors of the location. Star is blue. Okay. Green triangle, blue star. Green triangle, blue star. Is there an avian in my colon? Yes, there is. I saw her. So I'm playing Helen Keller is fucked up, but there are birds in my anus is fine, apparently. Yeah, we can't be ableist. All right. Blue star, green triangle. Thank you for the bits.
Save your bits for the subathon.
Save your bits for the subathon. But it's also, it's tech, so tech always says good morning. Good morning, gamer. All right, so chat. Oh shit, I forgot. There you go, good reminder. Yeah, save those shits. Subathon in 1 week. Hold on to those titties. Yo, bird nerd, this is the place for you to bird be right now.
Bird, bad news.
Good news, bad news, bird nerd. There's currently a demonic bird chasing us, so you are in the right or wrong
also
place.
Bad news, it's up our ass.
Bad news, it is in my colon. There are avians in my colonoscopy.
Locked up in that horizontal transverse colon.
There, yeah, it is there. Bird in the butt. I like that you saying locked up in the transverse colon and Reese says bird in the butt. That is
duality of man.
Duality of man is
the reason
is,
I switch off.
That's so true. It's one or the other. Either you're saying it in like a highly verbal way and she's like bird in the butt, or she's saying it like a really long, eloquently put way and you're just like bird in the butt. Like it's always one or the other. Okay. So what I'm hearing though is I'm gonna turn these two into this is gonna be a triangle and that's gonna be a star. And then the bird is going to chase me. And I have to run away. Is that right? And there's going to be a collectible on a shelf somewhere. Right? That's just going to happen. Listen, I'm not here for good gameplay. I'm not here to be entertaining for you. I'm just doing my best. Siri, how many birds can you legally shove up my ass? I don't think it's a legal problem. I think it's a biological one.
Two raccoons could fit up the human anus.
Two raccoons could fit up the human anus. Not in reality, but in a logistic standpoint.
In logistics. No one's tried. No one's been brave enough.
I'll be the man to cross that line. I will fit two
You're
raccoons
die
in my ass.
Put on your gravestone. Died because he shoved two raccoons up his ass.
Died for science?
Results were, you can't do that.
You opened my Siri. Oh, perfect. Chat, this is, I'm sorry to all of you. Siri, how many birds can you fit in the anus? Somebody has to answer. Somebody has to respond to that. And just in case it doesn't. Alexa, how many birds can I put in my anus? Somebody's will answer to that. Somebody will find out. You can. I'm just trying to piss off everybody in chat. I have an actual Amazon robot next to me that could research it for me. Do hummingbirds count? That's a good question. Joke's on you, I wear headphones. That's valid. Hummingbirds are indeed a bird. Yeah, I think it's very different if you're talking like ostriches or hummingbirds.
Not an answer.
It would be demented to let your stream play out loud. That's true. All right.
It's a lot of just, it can stretch 9 inches, so I guess how many birds can be 9 inches?
9 inches?
Yeah. Like 9 inch, like, circumference, I think. It might be diameter, let me specify.
Diameter is crazy.
Diameter
circumference
is crazy.
Would make sense. Diameter is crazy.
I think it might be circumference. It might be diameter.
If it's diameter, that's crazy. Circumference, that feels like, makes sense.
It says a human rectum can stretch up to 9 inches without tearing. A raccoon can fit through holes that are 6 inches. So I'm assuming
diameter.
Circumference. Not circumference, diameter. Because it's based on the width. So I think
9 inches in diameter?
Diameter is, in fact, possible.
My butt cheeks don't even spread 9 inches. There's no way.
You haven't tried.
I haven't tried. 9 inches?
I like this person asking, how many raccoons can you fit up your bum? They ask so politely.
So politely.
How big can raccoons get? What are these questions?
Sorry. Chat's like, please, let's go. Please, can we please? We're scaring the bird away. All right. So I'm assuming I'm going to have to start running. I don't know which direction I'm going to have to start running. This sucks. All right, I'm going down the slide. Let me out, please. Let me out, please. What do you mean, sensory time? I don't want to do this anymore. Emily, you do it.
I don't know how to play the game.
You just walk.
I'm working on my webtoon.
I'm gonna be honest, this is just a really long walking simulator that's kind of scary. My friend just said if you cook the birds, you could probably fit more. That's probably true.
I mean, steaks do get smaller when you cook
them. Yeah. Tondra said, yes, we need more webtoon.
I'm working on it!
That isn't fair. If you're, is dehydrating the birds cheating?
Can I put them through a freeze dry? Can I freeze dry them?
If I just shred them, it's infinite. I can put...
The mass doesn't go away. Mass cannot be created or destroyed. This is basic physics.
If I liquefy it...
It'll still be the same amount of mass!
No.
No matter what, unless you are cooking out the gas, if you liquefy it, it's going to be the same amount of mass.
I compress it into less bird.
The mass can evaporate, but you're not shoving bird gas up your ass unless you are specifying it when you cook it and you store the smoke along with the cooked bird and you shove both up there.
But I don't need to fit it all at once then. I can't fit a turkey up my ass, but if I liquefied a turkey and then enemaed it, it would be fine.
So you're gonna let it just become one with you.
Yeah,
you want to absorb.
I'd like to absorb the bird to gain its powers.
I don't think the colon can absorb anything. I think it's the whole point, is that it takes the garbage.
No, that's the whole point of the colon, is to absorb stuff. That's its whole job.
Well, the small intestine absorbs the good shit. The colon get all the bad shit.
The colon just whatever's left. If you put the turkey inside the event horizon and spaghettify it, yes, we need black holes to fit birds in our ass. I'm really putting this off. I don't want to get chased
just
by the bird.
Go through the tunnel.
I just don't know.
I'll be standing there here.
Honestly, I just don't know where it's going to come from. That's what's
here,
stressing
I'll
me out.
Help you. I'll be right here. This isn't worse. My boob showing up.
That's not helping. It's not changing anything. I think it's when I drop.
Let's just go. Just go.
Let me out.
It's letting you out. It's fine. Okay, the other direction. Yeah, go to the pool there. That's your ass.
Let me out.
Yeah.
Let me out. Let me out. Oh.
That the other direction.
Oh, what the hell?
She got you.
Oh, I flopped down.
She got pinned to the wall.
Bro, the lesbian pinned me up against the wall. She got me so quickly.
Yeah, she was pretty
good. She was nowhere near me.
That's a cool
picture. Oh, that's good art.
You were caught by Molly McCog.
Molly can repeat words that she's heard. Don't be fooled. Interesting. I jumped, man. I'm sorry. Okay. So this is...
So don't do that again. Now you know to go in the left tunnel.
Well, now I know to, I guess, pause and look. I'm not entirely sure, but now we know, Chad. It's okay. We're gonna open. There's gonna be a bird there.
There's gonna be a bird there.
We're gonna turn around. You're gonna let me in. Let me in. I'm gonna run.
Go left. She was in the front one. Yep.
All right. We're schmoving. We're schmoving. We're schmoving. Molly McCall needs to chill the fuck out.
She does need some Molly.
I fell.
Oh.
I just straight up fell.
You fell in the ball pit.
Oh, God. I was hoping it would get me across.
Your little legs could not do it.
Should have been me, not him. Yeah, Voracious, next time you get pinned by the lesbian. Except I'm sorry, but she doesn't want you. And unfortunately, she doesn't want me either.
I think she wants both of you dead.
All right, Molly McTitties. Send me in.
Leave this bird alone.
No.
You can't sexualize the one female character.
I sexualized the 100-year-old sad dragon.
You guys did really like that dragon.
All right. Let me in. I'm moving my fucking tiny little titties. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. Shmoove, shmoove, shmoove. Huh. Shmooving, shmooving, shmooving. I think that was the right choice.
Yeah. Surely.
I'm just going.
Your legs did not break.
I'm going. I'm schmoving. Oh, there's supposed to be a collectible somewhere around here. I don't remember where.
We all need collectibles.
Oh, fuck. Oh, come on! All of the other ones was jump, turn around, and you're telling me this one wasn't?
They can't keep it the same, because then you get used to it.
I got used to it.
I forgot Voracious is, in fact, the man who wants to be killed after sex, so... Should've remembered.
Yeah, she is.
Should've remembered.
She wants you dead. Emily, you know this changes nothing, right? Yeah.
Alex wants to be fucked and then immediately hung.
I want to be hung and then fucked.
Okay, so now this gets illegal.
Yeah, this is just illegal.
You have to really be specific with the order. Killing is fine, but fucking a dead body isn't.
Don't clip that. Don't clip that.
What's wrong?
No.
I stand by it.
Clip that.
You can kill people, that's like justifiable, but like, unconsensual sex isn't.
I'd like to die mid-sex, please. Is it-
Oh, like a heart attack?
Yeah. I want my last moments to be-
I pass away
yeah.
Orgasm.
I want my last moments to be an orgasm. I want to be like, immediately dead.
That can be arranged.
Deal. Reese, are you like offering or? Because I mean, like, I'm a kind person. I've never wanted to turn down like a generous offer. Pussy so good you have a heart attack. Yeah, TBD. Yeah, to be determined. Deal. All right, we'll talk about it at a later date. See, this is what you do for the homies. You make their dreams come true. You'd be like, you want to die mid coitus? Hey man. I'm here to back you up. I'm here to support your dreams.
I think I should be jealous, but honestly, I don't want to die, so I don't think I am.
I always.
That's all you, brother. That's all you.
Oh.
Get that.
I gotta go. She's in my ass. She's on my ass. I wish she was in my ass. I mean, she's fucking. Move. I've gone too far to die at this point. It would be really annoying, honestly. Keep moving.
Ah, there you are, buddy.
Hi.
Wait, hold on. This one's that only.
I don't care.
That sucks, doesn't it? Oh, dear God. So that's not an animatronic, that's just a bird.
Welcome to the Rambly's Wranglers Registered Will. Here we have plenty of
amenities. We just killed a girl.
I can see in your facial tracking that you're scared, angry, upset. Transparency is an important part of our policy here at Indigo Park, so I need to be honest about something.
Uh-huh.
The park has been inactive for years. Employees stop showing up, guests too. The mascots are... I just was so excited to see a visitor, and I wanted to be sure you were given the best experience possible.
I don't trust this raccoon.
The entrance for so long, I didn't realize just how much disrepair the park is...
Yeah. Oh.
Sorry for the inconvenience. But I have an idea. I have access to the repair documentation in my database.
Right.
I just can't execute most tasks without authorization from a human user. You must have come here because the park matters to you too, right?
Yeah, buddy.
Would you be willing to help me restore the park?
Yeah.
I can see in your facial tracking data that you aren't opposed to this.
Aww.
I'm so excited. Let's get this place back in business.
You're down a mascot, though. Like, pretty severely. But, anyways. A message got held for aggression of just me when I brutally murder a lesbian. What the fuck?
Guys,
welcome to the crew of Rookie Wranglers Registered. Your first official job as one of Rambly's Wranglers Registered is to get out of the Rambly's Wranglers Registered room. Head left towards the Rookie Wranglers Registered security room to set yourself free. Phew, kind of exhausting to say that whole spiel, but Rambly's Wranglers Registered is a registered trademark that expired yesterday.
Right. You had the, yeah, automod allow Dawn.
That sentence somehow was not a hate crime.
That's not one of the collectibles. I guess I do have that one already in that one. I know you said left.
Uh-oh, that Rambly's Wrangler's room is only accessible by Royal Wranglers. Maybe one day you'll grow up strong enough to enter it. But for now, don't.
Right. All right. Lesbian on lesbian crime is wild these days. What in the FNAF is this? Oh boy. All right, registered Riley. Let's go figure this out. Honestly, the game so far, this is chapter one. I do think it's got a good setup for a cute idea. I'm a fan of fucking Not My Roderick or whatever his name is. I think he's cute. He reminds me of, if you're from my generation of people, if you remember Fetch with Ruff Ruffman, that's gonna be a little bit of a niche one, because I think that was on a non-cable channel. So if you're from my generation and also didn't have cable, which is going to be a fairly large population of people, Fetch with Ruff Ruffman is exactly what he reminds me of. The way he moves, the way he talks, like, that is exactly what it sounds like. Oh my god, I got all of them. All right, let's listen to the ones we haven't heard.
Hey, buddy, did you dig that out of the lost and found? Or was it in the trash? No surprise, I guess, that our park would dispose of a non-Indigo brand toy. I suppose he'd make playtime special for a child with poor taste, though. Whoa, where'd you get that? Ramble berries are my favorite! Oh, if only I could jump out of the screen and take a big bite. Don't eat it! Maybe I'll be able to one day!
Aw. Rambly head.
Whoa, where'd you find that? I've never seen anyone wearing one. Pretty snazzy. Ooh, looks like there's an audio recording tagged with costume in my database I've never noticed before. Let's listen!
Ooh.
Hey, Jackson, you hear about the new mascots?
Yeah, think it'll put us out of a job?
I think so. Old sport. And right after we got this damn raccoon costume.
Man, screw this place. I say we get our asses out of here and go straight to Vegas.
Aw, come on. They didn't even document the Indigo inventory ID for the costume. I was really looking forward to that. What a useless recording. Deleted.
Interesting. What's the other ones we didn't have? It's this one. I think this is the only other one that we didn't have last time we were here.
I don't get why we even have those. Now why do they only make one of Lloyd? Is it because he's the loudest? I can be loud too! Where's my limited edition throwback plush? Where's Molly's? Where's Finley's? Give this mistake to a child and they'll cry.
Oh. Retroloid. Huh. Interesting. Well, alright. So are we done with the spooks? Oceanic Odyssey.
Oh no.
I'm coming.
Oh no. Yeah, you're gonna be coming.
I'm coming, Finley. Take me away.
Wow, you made it to Oceanic Odyssey.
Damn right.
You're doing a great job, Rookie Wrangler.
Thanks, man. Let me in. I'm so excited.
You'll find a pumper and porpoises, pickerels, and perches as far as the eye can see. Please don't tap the glass. I don't really know what else they need to
serve. Oh, 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 oh. That's so exciting! That's so exciting. I cannot wait.
Hey,
ooh, all right, everybody.
You okay? You look kind of tired. Do you need a moment? Don't worry, it's fine. I don't blame you for taking a rest after all that. Heck, I could go for a nice relaxing defragmentation myself.
A what?
But before you settle down, you up for a little survey to help us improve the park? Thanks for visiting Indigo Park. Hope all your dreams came true. If you've got some time and you're up for a lark, stick around for the Rambly Review.
All right.
I'm here to offer my best to each valuable guest I assist.
Deal.
And lots of happy feedback ensures I get to exist.
Let's try it.
Okay. Were you satisfied with the rides?
Yes or no?
Yeah.
Were you satisfied with your guide?
Oh, yeah.
Do you plan to come back? Will I see you again? Did your experience convince you to tell a friend about us? Did I earn your trust?
Damn.
At Indigo Park, there is a stark contrast to everything I know this place should be.
This shit pops off.
But out of the dark, you've given a spark of sunshine to this kingdom's faithful devotee.
God damn.
At Indigo Park, more than my remarks are mysteries, even I don't know what we might find. Through the dark, and I'll be your spark of sunshine to get you out of any bind.
This is cute.
That is, if you want to keep going.
I see.
Oh, idea! I know all of this isn't fair to you. It's an awful lot to ask. But here comes Rambly Review Part 2 to sell you on our task.
Right.
I'm here to view and assess each valuable guest as I learn.
That's me.
And lots of happy feedback ensures you're gonna return.
For sure.
Right. I'm so happy you rode a ride
and saw the show.
I'm so happy to be your guide.
More than you know.
So come back anytime. I'd love to see you again. In all my thousands of days, I've never had a friend like you. At least I hope I do.
Oh.
At Indigo Park, there is a stark contrast to everything I know this place should be. But out of the dark, you've given a spark of
sunshine
to this kingdom's grateful devotee.
That's fun.
Indigo Park.
This is a really smart way to do credits. Really smart way to do credits. Nobody's gonna skip if your song fucks. So many people are gonna be bopping this on Spotify.
Till all my old friends are united again, and I won't feel so left behind.
Aww.
Okay, I'll let you go. See you next time, buddy. Please?
Oh. And then I was told not to click off. I see. Full-on passion project I've been working on for a little over a year now. Cool. With the scale of the game, we're going to need some help. Please consider our socials if you want to see Chapter 2. No matter what happens, we hope you enjoyed your stay. Thank you for visiting Indigo Park. Awesome. Very cool. Very cool. That's crazy. I can't fathom a passion project like that. That is so cool. Honestly, I'm surprised it only took a year for the way that that thing looked. Like, a year is like a crazy little amount of time for a video game that looks like that. Like, that thing looks good, and it plays well. Like, other than the little side-scroller thing that controlled, like, ass, but, like, I get it. It plays well. Honestly, it was smoother to control than the fucking FNAF security breach. I hated controlling that thing. The controls were so ass. The Anus Birds was worth it. rate the experience out of 10. With you guys here, I would say it's, I'm not going to say it was like a 10 out of 10 game, like most mind-blowing game I've ever seen, but that's like, I hate rating things out of 10 because like, I wouldn't take off any points. I wouldn't say there was anything that was like, this made my experience bad, which makes me want to give it a 10 out of 10. But then if I ranked all of my video games at a 10 out of 10, unless they had something negative, then I would rank all of the video games that I enjoy as the same level of enjoyment. And like, this isn't God of War, but this is a really good game. And for what it is, I would highly recommend it. So like, I would say for a indie horror game, 9 out of 10. And it's for being an indie horror game that is like mascot horror, like Garden of Ban Ban, Five Nights at Freddy's, like making something cute and childish into something horror. I think it was fun. I think it's a little bit of a walking simulator. There were very few puzzles, and the puzzles that there were like next to nothing. It was like, find this one gear that is really like behind you. It's like, find this gear and you turn around and it's there. The graffiti one was smart. I think that one worked well. They did make it pretty obvious after you figured out the star was the graffiti. Once you figured that out, the other ones are like really obvious and in your face. I was very scored. The Lloyd maze was, I think, the best visual storytelling part of it. He's easily the scariest so far. So like, there was definitely a lot of like, I think, good environmental storytelling. Specifically, the Lloyd maze was really good, like, environmental storytelling in that area. The sound effects were really good. I like that there was some level of payoff, but it wasn't overdone. So I would say all in all, I think it was a really good game. Yeah, mascot horror was made to be a passion project. If it starts from a big brand, it's probably just a cash grab of the deteriorating genre. Yeah, you're pretty spot on. So that was fun. It did take me double the time that it should because I got distracted and talked about a bunch of stuff. Also, in the very end there, we had a follower. Xander, hello, welcome home. My name is also Xander. Good to have you here. Thanks for joining us. Yeah, that was a fun one. I liked Indigo Park. I have like the minor comments on it that I'd like whatever, if I was trying to score this as like a perfect game, I would say up your level of puzzles to say up the stress of it. Not like impossible, but not like child level difficulty. A very easy game and a little bit of a walking simulator, but a lot of mascot horrors do play a little bit like a walking simulator because it's about environmental storytelling. Yes, my name is almost Xander, not also Xander, but I am also almost Xander. Almost, but not quite. Part of it is also people need to know when to let their franchise rest or when to take a longer break to work more things out. Yeah, probably make like a finished game and not just like put out a half-finished broken game because your company said their deadlines due. Not at this game, at several other franchises out there, but oh, my back do be aching today. But that was fun. Thank you to the people who recommended Indigo Park. I think this was a very fun game to play. I could wrap today up since this was like a full 2-hour stream actually, and I don't have another game planned for today. Or if you guys are interested, I can save my stories for this weekend. Or if you're interested, we can lock down and do a story time right now about this weekend. But it is up to you guys. I'm going to go a little tight today for just this. Totally get it. Thank you, by the way, for all of your assistance and handholding. You have a great night. Anybody who was here specifically for the game, thank you for being there. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope I lived up to your expectations. I don't play video games like your average streamer does, possibly because I'm a pussy and also because I have ADHD, and I get distracted by things like liquefying turkeys to fit them in my anus. So, unfortunately, that's who I am. Story. First day of school today. I'm exhausted. Bro, I totally get it. Get some sleep. That's a fucking tiring day. Xander, you talk about the concert drama. Yeah, if people are down to have a little bit of a concert story time, we can have a little bit of a concert story time. I'll probably turn my lights back on because it's pitch black in here. Alexa, light on. Thank you. Hello. Welcome back to light. I'm also going to take this neon thing off because I'm very warm. And it's not necessary when I'm not in black light, although it looks very cool. Ugh. Ugh. Who knew we needed birds in our asses? You know what? And racist, yeah, lacist Lloyd. Sometimes I give you things that you never knew you needed. That's what I'm here for. I've been waiting the entire stream for this, yippee. All right, yeah, let's talk concerts. Let's talk concerts, motherfucker. I'm gonna switch my... Just chatting. Done. Also, I'm gonna let you guys have a stroke for a moment to some music because I have to piss right now. So please enjoy Jortstorm for the 30 seconds it takes me to pee. BRB. All right. I'm gonna throw on my liked songs for while I'm talking. But I will pause them for videos because I am pulling up videos for you. Oh, I should have my face back. Hello. Hi. I'm gonna pull up videos for you guys so I can also show you the things I want to show you. So, all right. Let's talk concerts. Hey, buddy, do you want to say hi to chat real quick? Oh, big neons. Oh. Hello, Apollo. Say hello, chat. Hello. You gonna chill here, or you gonna go somewhere? You gonna chill here? Okay. All right. I'll just be over here. So, this past weekend, I went home to my home state. That's why I was not, so I did not stream this weekend. I went home for a bunch of things, a doctor's appointment, my grandma's birthday, a concert, a party with my friends, state fair, there was a lot happening. Hey, buddy. You just gonna, should I, like, let me see if I can adjust my camera to include you. That's the closest I can get to, like, a cat camera. So, there you go. Hopefully that works for you. Yeah, Apollo's gonna tell the story here. I'm gonna, like, do this thing so then you can have some, like, support because so my legs can go down. Okay. There we go. All right. So I went up to a concert that was up in, it was about a 2-hour drive from my house. So I had to pick my friend Courtney up, drove 2 hours up to see an all-day concert. We got there at, like, 4 p.m., No. Yeah, 4 p.m. Because the doors opened at 4 and the concert started at 6. So yeah, it was like a 2-hour time to, like, get everybody in, get food, get water, get into the pit, get wherever you need to be, whatever. So we showed them at like 3:30. So we're like, okay, half hour before, doors open, like plenty of time. We were supposed to get there an hour early, but things got in the way, whatever. So we get there at 3:30. There is like literally no line, literally like no line at all. I was very surprised. I was like, that's weird. We were like maybe 20 people into the line. So we got in almost immediately, and there is two sections. So it was a baseball diamond with a stage at the front. And like the front half of the baseball diamond was the pit, and then the rest of the field was general admission. So we were like inside the actual diamond, and then everything outside of that was the general admission. We were in pit, so we headed in there. We immediately got into the pit and were like three people from the barrier. Like it is the barrier, person, me and Courtney. So we were up there, which was an awesome start. I ran and like got food and water, whatever, and like joked with the person at the concession stand who was like, yeah, there's like nobody here. And I was like, yeah, this is weird. I was like, we got here early expecting to have problems, but now instead we're just gonna sit and do nothing for 2 hours while we wait for this concert to start, which was fine. Now, I don't know if I've laid out exactly who was at this concert, but in reverse order, going from biggest to smallest, this was In This Moment, Einstein Kills, Avatar, and TX2. If you don't know who TX2 is, he is TikTok's new famous emo boy. You can have your opinions. I can't stand him. I can't stand... He feels like an industry plant. He feels like the definition of the word poser, which I know is a weird thing to call somebody because, like, it's emo music. Like, if you feel that way, you feel that way. But it doesn't often feel like he feels that way. It feels like he's making music for people that feel that way to make money off of them. Like, it's like everything he says is ingenuine and, like, based off of some kind of, like, emo joke. Like, he only knows the genre from making fun of it. Yeah, he constantly makes goth mommy jokes, like, all the time. It is something. And all of his music is fucking stolen. Okay, you know what? We're going to talk about this right now. We're going to talk about this right here, right now. I have a Google Doc. That's called TX2 Blows. Hang on, let me grab that. Let me grab my TX2 Blows document. Because I have a collection of all of his songs that I know are stolen from other people's fucking songs. And these are just the ones either I was able to recognize or I've been told by somebody. So I'm going to list them just so you can get some ideas. And then I'll play you one so you can hear what I'm talking about. His song Heaven Was Full is a ripoff of Highway to Hell. Black Wedding is an exact ripoff of Sarcasm by Get Scared. Take Some Drugs and Suck Some Dick is a ripoff of House of Wolves by MCR. Vendetta is a ripoff of Suffer by Get Scared. Vampire by Rumor is a ripoff of Pretty Handsome Awkward by The Used. And Degrade Me has an exact guitar ripoff of Nickelback's Burn It to the Ground. I know I sound insane, but it's like so specific. Let me pull up. This is the one that I caught that like drove me insane. And he played it. He played it there. Okay, I'm gonna play you Degrade Me by TX2. I want you to listen. Actually, here. Let me do it the right way. For those of you who don't know, I'm gonna play you Burn It to the Ground by Nickelback. I love this song, okay? I want you to focus very specifically on the guitar, okay? Listen to the guitar. Alrighty? Listen to this here, okay? This riff. And I'm going to make sure we get to the chorus because I need you to hear it. Okay, I'm going to skip over to the chorus so you can hear this. Oh, this is a vibe. You can listen to it for a second. It's a good song. For anybody who doesn't actually listen to Nickelback, this is your time. Listen to this. Okay, okay. We've heard it now. Okay, 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 okay. I'm gonna pull up Degrade Me by TX2. Listen to the guitar. Okay? It's girl, what? It is identical. Identical. Oh. No, keep listening. Awful. Listen. It's identical. The guitar is fucking identical. I fucking identical. Okay. This is just crazy. Okay. It's so weird. Yes, his voice is also, I'm not a fan of it. Apollo, leave it alone. Stop trying to get in there. You're getting kicked out of the room next time I see you pawing at that. Okay. I'm going to do one more for you because I feel the need to prove my point that I'm not just crazy. It's not just one song. I'm playing you Sarcasm by Get Scared, okay? I'm going to pull up Sarcasm by Get Scared. Okay. You've got me shaking from the way you're talking. It's a good song. Okay. This is a good song. We're also going to get to the chorus, okay? I'm going to let you guys just enjoy it with me. And I'm going to need you to focus on the chorus. Okay? Bones. All right. Listen to this. Okay? We're listening. Okay, we heard it, we heard it, we heard it, right? Okay, we were all listening. Cool. All right, so that's Sarcasm by Get Scared. I'm gonna pull up Black Wedding by TX2, okay? Here we go. Okay, Black Wedding by TX2. We're listening. Immediately. And it gets worse. The chorus is identical. Yes, Reese, this is the one you helped me remember. Identical. Listen. Like... What? Specifically this. No, look, sorry. This part drives me crazy. Like, that's just a ripoff. That's just a one-for-one copy. And like, I can understand it if it happened once, maybe twice, but there's lists. If you like Vampire by Rumor, go listen to Pretty Handsome Awkward by The Used. It's the same fucking song. Anyways, so that's just my take on him. I have some minor opinions. He also came out in what is the most awful version of goth makeup that I have seen, specifically because it was the white face paint with like the black like detailing, but it was like just around his face, and like it just it looked a little a little awful. I'm gonna be honest. I'm gonna see if I can adjust my display capture quickly. Yeah, I'm just adjusting slightly. Hopefully that you can like see that kind of okay. This is him up there. Apollo, get. You're gonna be in another room now.
Shoot.
Hey. Okay. Anyways. It's a little awful, but it's okay. I get it. Whatever. Hopefully you'll be able to hear this.
Quick, take a look in a pit. I'm a
Everybody was standing dead still. So it was a bit weird. It was a bit strange. He did come out and start with a cover, which was an adventure. And then he had these knee pads on his knees. I don't know if you could quite see it. He was really trying to hype up the crowd. Nobody cared. Except this one girl who was back to the right of me who had a sign that said, like, I don't even know, like, freaking for TX2 or something. Like, super excited for TX2. Like, it was a bit strange. But he had knee pads on, and he kept, like, during an important part of the song, he would be standing, and then he would, like, fall to his knees dramatically. And I was, like, a little confused about it, because it was, like, he did it, like, 5 or 6 times throughout the concert. Like, he wanted it to be, like, a big impactful moment, but, like, he kept doing it over and over again. What is this? Is this the... Oh, yeah. He demanded that we open a pit. And the pit opened up. And about 4 or 5 people went in because they just wanted a chance to pit, but nobody else wanted to. So it was something. He was right, like, look how close he is. This is not zoomed in at all. It was something. That's a really short video. I just wanted to show you how close he was to the crowd. He came down to the crowd. So it was an adventure. Anyways, so yeah, TX2, it was fine. I was polite, as I am with all openers. I cheered when I cheered. He did ask us to do Magic Fingers when his guitarist was playing. He asked us to do Magic Fingers and then did this and asked that we all do that at his guitarist. So we all were just doing that, which felt very kindergarten. It was a little strange. Like, it felt like he was, like, trying to lead a concert, but didn't quite know how, like, to get a crowd to, like, interact with you, or, like, it was a bit weird. It does feel Nepo Baby trying to fit in with the common folk, but emo version. It does give that. It gives Rich Person wanting to fit in with the emo crowd, but, like, it doesn't quite work. Anyways, yeah, he's the one who's famous for having the lyric, I'm a 5'4 man whore who slit his wrists. That's just a lyric in his songs. And I will say, when that song came on, everybody knows every word to that one, because it's like a huge joke. And like, it was one of those things, like, the song came on, and I was like, hey, this one's about me. And the man behind me burst out laughing and, like, high-fived me. And I was like, yeah, like, it was just really funny. But anyways, it was an event. So that was TX2. That's all I'll say about that. I'm gonna try and do the drama in order. So I'm gonna give you some explanations and show you the videos of Avatar first, and then I'll get into the drama, because there was drama. That was a silly song, but it lost the sparkle quick. Yeah, it did. I will say, it was a really fun song. I sang along to every word of that song because I thought it was fun, and it was a great time, and I cheered along because it was a fun song. Anyways, Avatar, if you have not heard of them, they are an old Swedish metal band. I had never heard of Avatar before now. If you like old style classic metal, like really like true classic metal, it's performative theater metal, but it is like the classic version of it. They were really fucking fun to watch. They had a like theater-esque like setup going on, so they were all in like theater like ringleader outfits, and the main singer was like the ringleader of it, and it was very cool because it seemed like throughout the entire performance he was in control of the rest of the band. Like he would like come out and all of them would be like 100% completely still, like the drummer and the guitarist and the bassist 100% still. And then he would like come out and like greet the crowd, and the other musicians would never like pay attention to the crowd. They were like locked in like zombies. And then he would like raise his hands and all of them would start headbanging in like perfect unison. Like they're all lined up in perfect unison headbanging. It was really, really fucking cool visually. And he was such a strong visual performer, because he was like supposed to be like this like crazy ringleader, and he had this smile that he did that was so cool. I spent so many videos trying to catch like a correct glimpse of it, but it was like this big wide mouth top teeth smile like that, but without any like stress to it. He was just happy, like he was just like the whole time, but it was so unnerving. He would do it while he was singing, and then he would just like stop and just like smile out to the crowd and then like go back to like he was such a good performer, and he had just so much good energy and such insane vocals. Yes, Emily is chilling in the background for the people who are concerned about the thing moving in my bed. Hi, Emily. So I'll give you a quick couple of Avatar videos. He was super super cool, so I'll show you the ones that I got for him. Not all of my videos are vertical like a loser. He was so fun. Like, I have a bunch of really short clips because I was just trying to get like his vocals and that smile. And you can kind of see it in this one when he's singing. Like he's just got like, I don't even know if it was, yeah, like that early on, like he's just got this like weird like smile when he sings, like there, that like is so fun. Anyways, let me show you a couple of them. Awesome metal vocals, awesome vocals. And there they are doing the fucking headbangs in perfect unison. Like just classic, weird ass metal. I was distracted. They also had this. Surprised the fuck out of me the first time this dude came out. If you can't tell, this is a masked slave, like, not like, like sex slave style, like leather masked dude in a kilt, who has brought out a can of oil, right, so just who then the lead singer just drinks out of.
Who's the man?
Like, just the weirdest experience. Just so strange. It doesn't have to be like a sex thing at all. It was just like your little leather slave boy bringing up some fucking bottles of oil for you to drink out of. I don't fuck gasoline cans. I have no idea. So it caught me so out of guard. I did not know he was going to do that. I'm so glad I caught that on video, because me too. Here's a good full size video so you can actually see everything. I also want to apply to be that guy. Like, this was just such a good view. This is not zoomed in at all. This is my view. This is how close we were. Thank you for that. But I was just giving like a view of what the crowd looked like and the stage. is such good music. It was such good music. Here's again the headbanging in fucking perfect unison as he's like... The energy is so strong. It was so strange. Yeah. So anyways, those are your couple. I think oh yeah, I have a couple of him. I'm letting you guys see all the videos. I take the videos, might as well show somebody. Like, it was just, they were so fun. And they all had so much hair. So much fun. Also, I don't know if you could see in that video, but he did spend half of the concert with his pants unzipped. He had suspenders on, so they stayed on, but his pants were just fully unzipped. I don't know if it was purposeful or not. He did zip them up on stage at one point, and like two songs later, they were unzipped once more. So I'm really not sure. I think this is the part. No. This is me trying. I kept trying to get a video of him doing the smile. Like, just the weird little, like, unnerving things. That shit. And his pants are unzipped. He's a middle-aged Swedish man, but I'm so into his performance. Like, I'm so into his performances. He kept doing the tongue thing, the freaky tongue thing. This is the one. Okay, hang on. Before I let you witness, pause, load, and then pause, please. Okay, so... At this point, he did a little talk thing, and then I started recording at the last piece of it, okay? So he was, like, doing, like, a thing right before the last song, and he's like, you know what, there are gonna be people out there who are gonna see me and see people like us, and they're gonna see me and go, you look like a freak show, right? And then they're gonna get a little bit closer to us, and they're gonna hear us, and they're gonna hear what we sound like, and they're gonna hear our music, and they're gonna go, you sound like a freak show, and we're like, yeah, we do, but then there's gonna be times... Where it's times that you can only experience in places like this, on nights like tonight, where you're together and we're all in this intimate little space and we're packed up next to each other. And then he does this.
I think I'm ready.
Sniffs himself. Absolutely dies.
It smells!
Yeah, so it was, we smell like a freak show, and I was like, damn right. Yeah, and sometimes they get close enough to say, you smell like a freak show. Damn, yeah, that is one of those things. It was very fun. And then they were just...
We're gonna tell everyone the Green Bay!
Yeah, it was very fun. It was super cool. So, that was Avatar. Those were the last ones from Avatar. And then he was just talking for the rest of it. So, anyways, those were the openers. Then we saw Ice Nine Kills and In This Moment. So I will take a break from showing you some videos to tell you a little bit of the drama. First, let me show you. The drama. Okay, so the drama took place in between Ice Nine Kills and In This Moment, but there's a lot of videos to show. So since we just watched a whole bunch, let me explain to you some of the drama. So first is in the space of one concert, the group of people that I surrounded myself with were two 18-year-old girls, a 23-year-old girl, a 26-year-old girl, and a girl that I thought was maybe like 15, 16. It turns out this she was seeing her for her birthday, and I was like, oh my gosh, happy birthday. She's like, yeah, I'm turning 14 next week. This was a 13-year-old child. All right. That's fine with me. Her older sister and her dad were also there in the area with us. But she was just 13. And her dad was the one that high-fived me during TX2. And her dad is also the one that pulled out and lit just like a fully rolled joint and just passed it among everybody in our little group. I did not because I don't, but a lot of the people around us did. And I was like, all right, that's chill. So she was like with her family and he was super chill. And me and him were like talking and joking. So he was fine with her hanging out in our group of people. And then during the Ice Nine Kills concert, during a mosh pit, he decided to do an old style crucifix jump where they pick him up like he is crucified by Jesus Christ and then throw him into the pit and did not get caught. And just completely speared his chest to the ground, and was very injured and had to leave. And so I was just like, all right, the 13-year-old is mine now. I have to hold on to her for the rest of the show. I'll get you to your parents when we're done. So they just left her with me. So I became I have a tendency to do that. I have a tendency for like adults to trust their teenagers with me, and I don't know if it's because I give off like teacher energy because I'm like legally trained to work with kids that age, or if it's just like my queer punk safe aura that people get. But like parents see me and they're like, yeah, you can watch my teenager, and I'm like, all right, that's my responsibility now. Thanks for the kids. I'll keep an eye on them. So anyways, that's that event. So I just acquired a teenager. And at one point it got way too hot and I ended up taking my shirt off, and the group I was with was like, bro, you should let us sign your binder. And I was like, yeah, if you've got anything to sign it with, sign the binder. I don't care. But they, could not find anything to sign it with until one of the girls pulled out her lipstick and was like putting it on and was like, yo, let me sign your binder with my lipstick. And I was like, all right, deal. And so all of them got together and signed. This was the group we were hanging out with. Signed my binder with all of their names. So I will never wear that binder again. It's now going to be a memorial piece. And then they wrote goodbye titties on my back. So this is now a memorial binder for the boobs. I'm not going to wear that binder anymore. Because I think that's just too cool to waste. So that was a fun piece. You got to go. No worries, Ark. Thanks for being here. Feel free to take a peek in later and see what the rest of the drama was, because it keeps going. It only gets worse from here, actually. It continuously gets worse. That group of people, by the way, throughout the course of that concert, managed to lose their one of them lost their glasses, one of them lost their wallet, and one of them lost their phone. And during all three of those, we managed to find them, but it was like, Jesus Christ. Yeah, black lipstick, it was awesome. So yeah, those were just those simple ones. There was one dude in the beginning. Oh my God. Before the concert even started, in like the 2 hour wait time beforehand, some dude muscle shoved his way to the front. And I was like, brother, I've been standing here for 2 hours. You're not getting in front of me. You can stand to the left of me. This is my spot. I've been here for too long for you to try to weasel tit your way in. And he's like, wherever I am is where the pit is. And I was like, I sure fucking hope so, brother, because I plan to be pitting today. And he's like, usually people follow me in because I'm not afraid to shove my way to the front. And I was like, you're not afraid to be a dick. Some people love to hear themselves talk. Oh, and he was just going on and on about it or whatever. And at some point he's like making jokes or whatever. He's like, yeah, we'll be fucking pitting it. And already I've got bad energy off this dude. And then at some point he like looks around and he's like, man, I just realized I'm in like the fucking vagina section of the pit, aren't I? I'm fucking surrounded by girls. And I could not help myself and immediately turned to him. I was like, this will be the most vagina you are surrounded by. Get used to it. And the way he just like, excuse, like was fucking like, oh, like joking about it or whatever. I was like, yeah, I hope you brought your vagina if you're going to fit in. Like, it was just the most like ridiculous. Like we were back and forth at each other and he seemed to be chill with me. Like we were like joking back and forth, but like, I was not joking. I was very annoyed with this dude, but he was like, oh yeah, you're on my side, aren't you? And I was like, no, brother, I simply am not. Like, it just immediately just, ugh. And at some point he's like, yeah, we better be fucking pitting. You better not be a bunch of pussies or whatever. Cause I'm gonna start shoving people around. You better bet we're going to get this shit started. And I was like, yeah, well, when the concert starts and we're not standing here doing nothing, I'll be so excited to pit. Like, don't you fret. And he's like, yeah, I'm gonna start shit. Don't you worry. I'm gonna start shit. And he goes and shoves the girl that's next to him. Who is the girl next to him? The 13-year-old. This man, who must have been 23 at the youngest, like definitely around my age, he felt like maybe 25, puts both hands on a 13-year-old girl and shoves. So I catch her and I immediately like, I take her and I like put my arms around her and turn around. So I now have the child and her dad jumps in and like, hand to this man's face is like, nope, like completely removes him from the situation. And the dude's like, oh, whoa, whoa, sorry, 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 sorry. And he's like, no, out, out, out. Like, that dude did not come back to our area the rest of the night. He, in fact, was not the pit. Actually, in fact, do you know who was the pit? That 13-year-old. She's the bitch who started the pit. And I was like, damn right. And I joined in. It was awesome. So yeah, he was. The drama. I have never seen a full-grown, like, 25-year-old man put both hands on a 13-year-old and shove. I was like, mm-mm. Not under any circumstances. I literally just, like, abducted the child, and I was like, nope, and, like, took her away. Because I was like, dad's already in there. He's gonna fight the bitch. I don't have to worry about that. I'm gonna go play with the child in a group of girls who just want to joke and have fun together. Okay? Yes, let's go talk with the girlies. They're talking about My Hero Academia. We like that. Let's go talk over there. So that was that event. I'm almost out of fucking coffee. I have like fucking nothing left. How do I go through so much goddamn coffee? So anyways, there was that event. We have one more. I'm trying to think if there's any other extra story before the absolutely crazy one. I don't think so. Okay. No, I've got two, but I'll tell them in the order. Sir, is that a whisk in your cup? Like, not quite. It's, like, the end of, like, a hand mixer. Pull that out of the cup again. Let me see. I mix with whatever my heart grabs out of the drawer, okay? And my heart grabbed the end of a hand mixer. Fuck you. My coffee's well mixed. Maybe take a double take. The days that you guys don't ask what I'm mixing my coffee with is the days you'll never know, because it's whatever my heart grabs, whatever the world tells me to grab. But yeah, okay. I'm gonna get you. How are any of you surprised by this anymore? This is also not the first time I've mixed coffee with a hand mixer. It's not even the first time you've caught me with it. No, Rhonda. Not Rhonda. Don't bring Rhonda into this. She did nothing. Anyways, I'm going to give you guys some videos of the Ice Nine Kills concert. Yeah, you can ask what our spoon is again. It's some you can ask whenever you like, and the answer may or may not be what you hope it is. The Ice Nine Kills concert. If you've never seen an Ice Nine Kills concert, they are theatrical metal. So they are metal music, but like with an emphasis on a theater performance. So if a theater kid did metal, that's what this is. And all of the songs are based around like 1990s, it feels like 1970s, 1980s themed horror, specifically around the movies. So like Nightmare on Elm Street, like Freddy Krueger style shit, fucking Stephen King's It. They've got like a Georgie on stage and everything. They've got, like, they have the old style TVs up there. Like, they have a song called The Curse of Crystal Lake. Like, it's that story. It's like classic horror slasher movie theater metal. So I'm going to show you some of the videos from Ice Nine Kills, and then I will give you the most dramatic story of the entire concert. So let's I'll show you all this. Let's do this part first. Anyways, look at the cool dude up there. They had this huge animatronic, like, not animatronic, but like blow up dude in the back. He was so cool. And I won't play all of it because this is like a 2 minute long video. But I wanted to show you guys, like, this is how they introduce it.
Combining these two elements is what has made Spencer Charnas and Ice Nine Kills household names.
Like, it's just a really cool intro. No, Creep Pushing Kid was not dramatic enough. It gets much worse. Look, yeah. Here you go. This is where it gets cool shit. Just zombies. Okay, to give you some context right now, okay? Mindstormish has identified. This is the song Rainy Day, right? This is the song Rainy Day. Do you know what began happening the moment Rainy Day started? It had been cloudy. There had been chances of rain, but the weather had cleared us. No rain, right? Rainy Day starts. And it starts fucking raining in an outdoor concert. A little bit of a drizzle, and then the song starts, and it's just fucking pissing it down. Like, full raining. And by the time the song ends, it stops. And we're all just standing there in awe of being a group of people who got to see Rainy Day in the fucking rain. And are just standing there dripping wet, and it's not raining anymore. It was just the coolest thing ever. The dude in front of me, you can kind of see his blonde head right here. The dude in front of me, when it was dumb, he turned around like a kid in a candy store to me, just a random person behind him. It was like, that was the coolest thing ever. And I was like, that was the coolest thing ever. He's like, Rainy Day. And it's fucking, that was so cool. And like, we just had like a boy moment of just like pure joy out of just how cool this was. It was so cool. Anyways, here's some zombies. Yeah, here, this is Tyrio being scared over there. It was so cool. And then there's just a bunch of white boys in cargo shorts, of course, because that's what this band is. And I'm trying to show you, it's raining. It's so hard to see, but it's just full on raining. Like, it was so weird. Anyways, it was so cool. But this really is like an awesome theatrical band with the coolest like idea ever. And it's literally just a bunch of white boys in cargo shorts, unfortunately, but we'll take it. There's this van. Just a dude literally being carted around, like physically wheeled around. And he's just in like in the fucking straight jacket in the mask. Just so strange. So there's that. Oh. Yeah, I was trying to get a picture of that. So, oh, wait. There you go. There's just him. Yeah, the rain was just the people pissing from the top of the stage for effect. That simply was not, I promise. So yeah, there's him being up there looking like that. This. That is a son with an axe. No idea why this was playing. No idea what was happening at this point. I had no idea what was going on. why were we playing Walking on Sunshine? I don't know, I'm gonna be honest. Have a good night, Bracious. So yeah, anyways, there was the sun, and Walking on Sunshine. Here was Georgie. And then I caught this part on video. So I wanted to show this because this is dope. Just goofy, cool stuff. And now he just has his hand. It's so just like, it's just an event. There is an axe murder happening. Just trying to find the actual axe murder here real quick. There was a lot going on. There we go. Okay. Wait, let me back up. Let me back up. Let me back up. There you go. Just beats him up. And then we are just chopping a man's head off. Because that's what you do at an Ice Nine Kills concert, is decapitation. And then he just has a head. So anyways, that's what an Ice Nine Kills concert is like. There's my binder. You've sat through the Ice Nine Kills videos. Are you ready for the drama? And then I'll show you in this moment. No head? Yeah. All right. You ready for the drama? Here's the real drama. Here was the craziest thing I think I've seen happen at a concert, in all truthfulness, okay? Ice Nine Kills ends, they leave, okay? And now we're setting up for In This Moment. In This Moment is high-level theatrical metal, okay? So where Ice Nine Kills is theatrical metal, they have events going on stage, but they are also performing a concert. They're running around, they're interacting with the different musicians on stage, they're telling a story with, like, other background actors, but they're, first and foremost, performing a concert. In This Moment is theatrical metal, through and through. She is not here performing a concert for you. She is not here to speak to you. She is not here to interact with her other band members. She has a musical that is going on in front of you. She is an angel sent from heaven. She is a demon straight from hell. You are to sit down, shut the fuck up, and stare at her the entire time. You do not mosh it In This Moment. You mosh at Ice Nine Kills. You're having a good time. You're jumping around. People are crowd surfing. When In This Moment comes on, you sit down, you shut the fuck up, and you stare at the most beautiful woman you've ever seen in your entire life, and you don't make a goddamn sound. Except for screaming. Lots of screaming. Okay, just so you know. So the setup time is about an hour, right? Ice Nine Kills end, and we have an hour where In This Moment is currently setting up, because it is an event. They, like, put up a curtain and everything, and we're like, no. It's time you're focusing. So in this time, about halfway through this time, a man comes up from, like, the back of the pit, and it's like an adult man, and he has, like, what must be a six-year-old in front of him. Like, he's walking with his hands, like, here on the kids, on both of the kids' shoulders. So he has to be, like, genuinely six, okay? And he's like, he wants to be up front. Let's get him to the barrier. Like, let's let him into the barrier. And I was like, oh, yeah, dude. Fucking six-year-old, and In This Moment, this is your first concert. Let's get his ass to the barrier. Like, yeah, we were, like, parting the seas. We were letting him in. So he got all the way up to the barrier, except for, like, the people actually at the barrier, because most people in the barrier will not move, even if it's for a six-year-old. They're here for a reason. They've been here, standing here for 8 hours at this point. They're not moving for your six-year-old. So he gets essentially to the barrier. And now remember, I'm three people from the barrier. So now it goes barrier people, man with a child, me. I'm not, like, with him, though. We're, like, separated by, I would say, like, five or six people, but, like, I can see him and the kid, okay? And the kid has, like, full avatar face paint, which is crazy. But like he like full Avatar face paint style stuff, like the circus stuff, whatever. And when I first like, I don't really catch a glimpse of his face, but he like gets up to the front of the crowd or whatever. So I'm like, all right, whatever. One person pushing their way up to the front, that's fine. And then like 5-6 minutes later, a woman comes shoving through the crowd. And at this point, I'm frustrated because a lot of people have been trying this. I was like, man, I don't care what your excuse is. Your boyfriend's up there. You forgot your drink. You had to piss. Whatever. We've been standing here for hours. If you wanted to be at the front, you should have been there. She's like, no, I'm trying to find my kid. And I was like, yeah, everybody's fucking excuse is that. And she's like, no, someone has my kid. And I was like, how old's your kid? She's like, 6. And I'm like, that one? And like, point to the man. And she like, shoves past us to the kid. And I'm like following her at this point. I was like, do you know him? And she's like, no, I don't. She gets up to him. And apparently, the situation was that her and the kid were not in the pit at all. They were at the barrier in general admission, the barrier to the pit, right? And the man saw him with the face paint on and was like, he wants to be up front, doesn't he? And took the kid over the barrier into the pit and took off with him to the front of the stage. Just dipped. So when she gets up to the man, he like puts his hands up, whatever, and then backs out of the crowd and disappears into the crowd or whatever. And she's just talking to us about what had happened, which was just full on a kidnapping, just straight up mid-concert kidnap, which is just ridiculous. And then, of course, like 5-10 minutes later, the fucking stage crew push through the crowd to get to her and him. And they're like, we talked to you before, because she had to get a wristband to be let into the pit to come find her kid. So they come and find her and the kid. And we're like, we need you to come with us, like, because you guys didn't pay for pit tickets. And also, we need you to identify the man, because we think we found him. So they leave with the crew to go and identify the dude who tried to kidnap her kid. So, anyways, saw that at the concert, because genuinely, what? Like, actually what? So anyways, saw the kidnapping at a concert. That was an event. That's just something that happened. So, thought I'd update you about that. He didn't want the kid at the front. He wanted to be at the front. Yeah, genuinely. Just so weird. It was just so... I've just never seen anything like that before. Like, it was just so weird. We also had this one lady who was staying next to me who was so pissy about, like, she was so drunk. And me and this dude that was next to me were, like, bumping it up. We were having a really good time. And there were about 2 people in that pit. One on the left side of me, the drunk lady, and one on the right side of me, another drunk lady. Because it's always drunk women in their 30s. Always. Every single time I run into a person like this, it is a drunk Karen in her fucking 30s. Every time. Except for this crowd, actually, you're right, I had 3. 2 drunk Karens on either side of me, and 1 man who is felt a little bit younger than them, but just one dude on the left, on the right side of me. And these bitches were the type of people who were like, absolutely no moshing. I don't want any moshing around here. And I was like, madam, you are at the very, very, very front, at the barrier of a metal show. There will be moshing. I don't give a fuck what you want. If you don't want to get shoved around at a concert, you either need to be at the barrier or in the back or on the sides. If you want to stand front and center in the middle of a metal concert, the price you pay for good view is the fucking pit. If you want to stand at the fucking barrier, the price you pay is getting landed on by all the fucking crowd surfers. If you don't want to deal with the pit or the crowd surfers, stand at the sides or stand at the fucking back. That's the trade-off. That is the agreement you make when you go to a concert. There are prices to pay for the good places to stand. You don't get to bitch and whine and moan because I don't want to get shoved around. I don't care. You are at a metal show. I literally couldn't care less. So, like, as I'm, like, pitting around with a bunch of people during Ice Nine Kills, the one lady behind me, the drunk lady on my left, is, like, shoving me back away from her. Which, like, I totally get. If you are on the edge of the pit and somebody gets shoved into you, you're meant to shove them back into the pit. She is doing the right thing. But I'm talking like elbowing me back into the way and like riding up against me to stop me from bouncing around or whatever. And like she was just causing me so many issues. And then of course when the Ice Nine Kills concert is over, she's like pointing at this other dude who I was like excitedly pitting with. And she's like, this guy doesn't fucking get it. He's fucking so annoying, and he's just trying to get in my fucking way and fucking stand in front of me and not let me see the show. And I was like, uh-huh. But she's like, but you get it. You understand. You get where I'm coming from. You understand me because we're the same. And I was like, bitch, I don't fucking know you. And I was like, uh-huh. And as I'm, like, nodding and she's talking, I'm, like, looking at the guy that she's hating on that I was just pitting with. And I'm looking at him, and I'm like, help the entire time. And he's just fucking snickering at me. Like, he's laughing. Because, of course, she's just fucking talking to me. And I can't get her to shut the fuck up. And I'm, like, trying to get away from her because she's driving me crazy. And he's just fucking laughing at me. And I was like, sorry, brother, I'm going to go this way. And I stand on the other side to get away from her and the girl next to me. And I was like, yeah, whatever. Like, I don't know if we're going to be pitting at the same way for in this moment because it's a different type of metal. And the girl to me, she's like, you guys better be the barrier then. If they start pitting, you guys better stop this from getting over to us because I don't want to deal with any of that bullshit. And I was like, ma'am, I am the pit. We were the people who were just mosh pitting at the last concert. This was the pit. I'm not the barrier. I'm not stopping them. I'm going to be the bitches bumping into you. L. Like, it was just, like, she was so pissy about it or whatever. And one dude was, like, the other guy that was near her was, like, literally ready to fight. Like, ready to fist fight. And I'm just bumping around into people, having a good time at a concert, because that's how concerts work. If I was crowd killing, like, if I was the only person jumping around and shoving people, I would understand them being upset. And I didn't do it during In This Moment when no one else was doing it. But you bet your tits that I was doing it at Ice Nine Kills, because a lot of other people were doing it with us. That is how it works. And unfortunately, it was not an organized pit. It was a mid pit, so it was just happening, so it was whatever. Anyways, those are the people who were driving me a little bit crazy. Let me show you some In This Moment videos, because In This Moment has to be one of the coolest bands I've ever seen visually in terms of performance. I will fully admit, I am no better than any other man. As soon as this girl came out on concert, came out on stage, my face went and did not move for the entire performance. Just the whole time. The group of girls I was with were all equally gay. They were all screaming about her, and she would like do something and we'd all scream and like flap our hands together and then stare back up at her. And at some point I was staring slack jaw literally at her. And the group turned around and, like, somebody elbowed each other and, like, pointed at me. And I was like, huh? And they're like, you are mesmerized. And I was like, woman. Like, just the whole time, okay? You'll understand when you see her. I want to show you what we saw when it opened. Because I need you to see, right? Almost fanboy, no real. Almost very, very, very into women. And I did not realize humans could, should, or would look like this, but goddamn. So, creepy dude, child yoinker, not two, but three anti-moshers and a hot, hot lady. Yeah. So, this was the thing. They teased us with this shit. This mod might get muted for this. I was so excited, me and the group. It was so fun. So fun. I think I have a video of it like this too. I think I kept recording. I sure did. Snow white cheap perfume. For a smile they can share the night. It goes on and on and on and on. They just, it was so fun. Up and down the boulevard. It's just, there's something cool about singing it with a crowd. Anyways, so this is what it opened to. Just watch this with me. Look at what I'm seeing on stage. I'm immediately enraptured by the angel in front of me. It's just... Everybody gets their phones out, of course. Because look at what's in front of you. It's just so cool. I'm letting you guys watch this with me so you can experience it with me. Like, this is magic. So fucking strange. Like, she's just so fucking cool looking. And this is like, the most of this is literally just her standing there. Oh, here, let me back up slightly. Hold on. I just don't want you to have to watch the entire 5-minute video, but also. Like. Crazy. Crazy. She's so... So gorgeous. And then look at the fucking... The hands! Okay, I'm showing you more. Look at how cool she looks. I took some really fun pictures. Look at that photo. Girl. Those masks, though, are everything. Everything. So fucking cool. Like, they're just so cool. I took so many pictures and videos of her because I was like, holy shit, man. Cool. Okay. This is where I realized I was like, oh my god. She's stunning. I'm lost. Like, she's just so... This song and this outfit specifically. Jaw on the floor. And she's such a good performer, man. Such a good performer. But like, the music, the masks, the outfits, the worshiping dancers around her, the flames of hellfire behind her. She had an outfit change for every single song. She would disappear and was in a new outfit over and over and over and over and over again. And it was so fucking cool. Like, come on now. This is insane. visually actually insane. Obsessed. She is the moment. She is iconic. She could command an army. And I would follow her to the ends of the earth. She has such a fucking stage presence. It is every detail, and you can see it in some of the videos later. It's how she holds her hands. It's how she holds her head with the mask. It's how she holds her feet. Anytime her feet leave the floor, she's barefoot. Anytime her feet leave the floor, they are pointed, they're elegant, they are graceful. Every movement is, it is awesome. I think this is the video where you can kind of see that, like, she is so... Every one of her fingers knows where she is, like, it's so intentional. Like, the intention of walking down those stairs. The girl next to me going, "No fucking way!" I gotta head out, Nijuno. Yeah, I am so gay. Yeah, anyways, absolutely insane. This is her with the sex hat. That hat does just say sex. That is what that hat says. I can. Tis the sex hat. Don't mind the sex masks as well. Great event. These are thigh-high, like, leather boots. The event, the moment, she is the queen. I am in love. Love the sex hat. This. She did a cover of, I can't even remember the name of the song right now, but it's a Nine Inch Nails song. She did a Nine Inch Nails cover. Fucking ethereal. Yeah, very demure sex hat. Very demure. But this visual, she knew how intentional every moment of this was. And I kept trying to get pictures because, like, look at her. She looks like a fucking painting. I could not have painted her in a better position. At the fingers, the feet, the seat, the cloth, the lighting. Like, there is not a moment that she doesn't look like a literal fucking painting. Like, she looks inhuman. It is so intentional. It is so gorgeous. I was obsessed the entire time. Absolutely obsessed. Like, trying to get the right photos. And then she comes out with another very demure, very chic, very, very pleasant. This says whore. This is probably like 10, 15 feet tall, right? Big thing. And she came out with, so there's the Hellfire of the Damned behind the horror thing. And then she had these little people come out. And this is where we were at. She has a giant hat on. The hat also says horror. The screams.
Just a small girl, that I would amount to absolute shit. that I would become nothing but. So you see, this last song is about rising above all these ridiculous ideas and perceptions who and what we should be. So if I can help inspire turning any of this dark hate into love, then I am proud to say to you tonight, ladies and gentlemen, I will be your
So what she was saying there, if you couldn't understand it over the voice modulation, is that she was told ever since she was a little girl that she would amount to absolute shit. And so she decided to live up to more than what their expectations had been. And if she can turn any ounce of that hate into love, then ladies and gentlemen, she will be proud to be your whore. The whole point was like reclamation of the word, like being like, yeah, you want to say I'm a whore? Fuck you. I will be a whore. And the lyrics of that song are literally like, you hate me for all the things you want me for. Like, it's so good. Here's a tiny taste of. So yeah, she just stood on this like 15 foot tall platform and commanded an army of whores. And it was just wonderful. It was a wonderful experience. There's me afterwards. I will say my last piece of drama did come right at the very end of horror. As she's like encoring it, like the song ends, but she's like still going, like rallying the crowd on. And this dude in the back starts launching himself forward, like practically over people, trying to climb atop people to get to the barrier, screaming like, she's mine, I want her, she's mine, I'm gonna have her all for me. Like, clearly drunk, really gross, didn't like him. And so I was like, ah, okay, it's the end of the concert, I'm willing to have problems, hut hut, like, hands up, arms up, elbows back. And every time he jumps forward, I'm like launching myself backwards, shoving him back off of the line of young girls in front of me. And like, every time he'd be like, I paid as much tickets as you did, I deserve to be up front. And I'd be like, nope, bonk, like shoving him backwards. Cause I'm like, it's the end of the concert. If I get hurt at this point, whatever, bonk, like my whole body weight shoving this dude fucking backwards. And he's fucking flipping his shit or whatever. And I, whatever, he was very clearly drunk. He didn't seem violent, but he was very clearly causing major issues. So I was just fighting him off and keeping the girls safe while they were enjoying themselves. And I was like, yeah, that sounds right. At the end, like, the girls thanked me for whatever. And I happened to see, yes, I can share the TX2 doc. I happened to see her throwing, like, a bunch of, like, the picks out. And I saw where one landed. So I, like, scooped down and, like, grabbed it out from under a couple people who were looking. And, like, fisted it in my hand. Like, closed fist. Like, I look like I'm gonna hit somebody, but I'm just holding a guitar pick in my hand. And everybody else is still looking for the pick that's over there. And I was like, it's mine. I'm walking away. And the other girls are like, bro, like, thank you for keeping that dude off of us. I was like, no worry. It was worth it. Like, pudding, I have the pick. And they're like, oh my God, that's so fucking cool. And the guy who I was trying to keep off of me sees it. And he's like, give that to me. And I'm like, don't fucking touch me. And it's like, whoa, it was a joke. Like, I don't know why I was like at the very end of the concert. I was like so on edge because I was tired of this dude. I thought he was going to be problematic. And so, like, he like, and as I, like, showed it up and opened and closed my fist again, he's like, give that to me. And he put his hand on my shoulder. And I literally, like, don't fucking touch me. Like, wild eyes style thing. And he's like, whoa. Like, I was fucking joking. You didn't know I was fucking joking. And I was like, I don't believe you. I don't believe you, bitch. Like, I was so at, the, like, the end of my line. But, like, that group of people, there was, like, three or four girls. Well, there were, like, two girls and, like, three boys who were, like, still crawling around on the grass, picking up, like, soda cans and shit after, like, the lights have all turned off, the crowd is gone, like, leaving, the people are starting to come in to clean up all the recycling and shit, so I, like, help pick up a bunch of the recycling and throw it into the trash, and these group of people are still, like, looking through all of the trash, trying to find the pick on the ground, and I was like, you, what do you guys, like, did you guys lose something? And they're like, no, like, she threw a pick over here, and I can't find it, and I was like, oh, I'm sorry, I picked it up from, like, right underneath you. And they're like, oh, and one of the girls was like, man, I really fucking wanted that. Like, she, like, looked really sad, and she's like, no, I'm glad you got it, though. Like, you know, have a good night or whatever. And I was like, yeah, no worries. And I was talking with a couple people and helping pick up some trash, and she just came back over to talk to her boyfriend. And I, You know who I am. I do this at every concert. I have never brought home something from a concert. Never. I've never brought something home because I do it at every concert I go to. I see somebody who wants it more than I want it. And I want the moment more than I want the item. Picks, full guitar sticks that I've caught, set lists. I've never gone home with the thing that I've caught. So I like waved her over and I was like, hey, here. And she's like, what? And I was like, just like, have the pick. And she immediately is crying. She's like, really? And she like drags me along and like is like hugging me. And she's like, I don't know you, but I love you. And I'm like, it's okay. Like, this means more to me. Like, you take the pick home. Like, so, so happy. And she like waved her boyfriend over and was like excitedly showing him and all of his friends and everything. It was really good. So that, again, that was one of those things that like meant more to me than taking home a piece of plastic. Like, if that's what you need, girl, like, take it home. So, anyways, back to me being like that, because that's the person I am. I own one drumstick, and it is one that I ordered from a tour that I went to. They were selling signed ones, so I ordered it online. I've never brought home something I've caught in a crowd. It just, I know I could, but, like, unironically, like, the feeling and, like, the interaction that I get from people when I get to give them that means more to me than, like, actually having the thing. I don't think it's me being, like, a better person than anybody, like, Dawn saying, like, you're a better person than me. It's not me wanting to be a better person. It is, like, quite genuinely, like, I guess selfish in a different way. Like, because, like, if the pick was the thing that brought me more joy, I would take it home. If that was, like, I really love, like, this pick means so much to me, I would take it home. But it doesn't. It's like, it's cool, and maybe I'll hang it on my wall, but it's not life-changing. It's just kind of cool. Versus, like, for some people, that's everything. And I have, like, way more fun seeing somebody that excited and, like, being the person who gets to make their night for them that, like, maybe they'll remember me. And I know I'll remember them. And, like, that means more to me. So, like, that, it's selfish in my own way. It's like, I'm benefiting from this, and so are you, but we're just benefiting in different ways. It's funky. It's definitely not a selfless act of like, this means so much to me, but I know it'll be better in your hands. Like, it's not that much. It's not that for me. But yeah, anyways, that's pretty much all of the drama of the TX2 Ice Nine Kills In This Moment Avatar concert. That is the long and short of the drama of that world. It only took me an hour and a half to tell you all of it. But yeah, anyways, that is the, unhand me, you wench. No, genuinely, that's the concert drama. And after that, I had to drive 2 hours home. I got home at about 2 a.m., and then I immediately went to bed, woke up at 8 a.m. so that I could drive out to State Fair, spend all day at State Fair with my friend until about 7 p.m. when I got home, got dressed, changed clothes, and then ran over to my other friend's, birthday glow-in-the-dark neon party, which he saw my outfit for, and was like, I'll just sleep at your house and then drive home in the morning. And, like, you know, by about 2 or 3 in the morning, almost pretty much everybody had left except for me, Aurora, the girl who had hosted it, Air, a girl that I had made friends with, and Hannah. The four of us were the only people left at about 3 a.m. Hannah went to bed about 4 a.m. We got hungry, we made some noodles, we ate noodles, and we sat on the floor and started talking. Like, just, like, talking to each other, like, about just everything. It started as mostly just trans stuff, because suddenly Aurora found herself in the room with two other trans people, and we're like, I got questions. And then I was talking to Aurora, and I looked up past her at the window, and I was like, guys, it's light out. Why is it light out? It was 7 a.m. We had stayed up the entire night, the whole night. And at that point, we're like, fuck it, and took blankets out into the grass and watched the sunrise in the middle of ass crack and nowhere, because, like, she lives in the middle of fucking nowhere, so it's like dead silent with just the noise of the birds and like a gorgeous sunrise, and just like listened to like really quiet music and just talked and like had this like moment of like being a human for a second where I was like, oh, that's what life is supposed to be like. This weekend was like how it's supposed to feel. And I did not sleep. I helped Aurora clean up the party. By the time me and Air were talking, at one point we looked over, and Aurora had her face up to the sun, and her head had slouched down, and I looked over to her, and I was just talking to Air again, and I just heard snoring, and she had fallen asleep like this, like fully still sitting up, head down, completely unconscious, full snoring, which was so funny. So we ended up getting her up. I was like, all right, come on. Like, took her upstairs, laid her down. She passed out in bed immediately. Me and Air talked for a couple hours more. Well, I got my stuff ready together and cleaned up the house a little bit. And then I went upstairs to say goodbye to Aurora. And I, like, tried to shake her awake. She wasn't waking. So I crawled onto the bed. So I was kneeling behind her. I was like, hey, I gotta go. And, like, kind of, like, tugged her. And she, like, rolled over into my lap and was, like, very clearly trying to talk. But none of it was English. Like, it was English words, but, like, it was not sentences. I was like, oh, you're unconscious. And, like, gave her a hug, and she hugged me back. And she was like, it was, like, something about Jesus and out of the window. And I was so scared, but she's, like, looking really happy. And she's like, and it was, and like, but it was, like, none of it was words. It was just strings of nonsense English. And then I, like, rolled her back under her side, and she passed back out again, and I left. So I just shot her a text afterwards. I was like, if you're confused, I tried to say goodbye to you. You were not coherent. I left. Me and Air, like, went home. We didn't lock the back door. Like, we went out or whatever. Have a great night. Like, thanks for having us over. She woke up, like, 6 hours later and was like, I'm so sorry. But I literally went from her saying goodbye to my grandma. And then I had been awake for 32 hours. I was like, oh, well. And had to start the five-hour drive home. It was the worst drive of my entire life. I almost passed out the entire time. Never drive drowsy, kids. It is just as dangerous as driving drunk. I was on call with a bunch of people trying to keep me conscious the entire time, and they were very helpful. So anyways, that is the story of my crazy weekend. I stayed awake for 38 hours for a party. I saw a bunch of concerts. I saw the sunrise. I felt alive. It was a great time. So that is my excuse for why I was gone. I hope that is a valid reason. I hope that that justifies my absence, if you will. But yeah. That's the story. That's about all I got for you guys today. I'm pretty much all wrapped up. Unless you guys have any questions or anything you wanted to hear or know. Sounds fun, but man, I'd be unpeopled for the next 100 years. Luckily, I am nowadays in my life, I believe I am now an extrovert. I do get tired around certain people, and masking is really, really hard. So the more I have to mask in a group of people, the harder it is. But for the most part, experiences like that, like, they do more for me than they take. Like, truly. So, any hoota boodles. It was a good time. I had a good time. I had a fun experience. And that's all I gotta say. Sounds like actually such a great time, though. No, genuinely. So, thank you guys for recommending the game today. I'm gonna try and get you guys wrapped up and sent over to another stream. If you guys have any other game recommendations, especially if they're free, I'd be happy to do them. Also, quick question for the people who are my dedicated viewers who are here late at night listening to my bullshit rambling for the past 2 hours. Question for you guys. I'm considering picking up a new skill, and it is a skill I will learn on the computer. So in theory, I could stream it. Major question is, if I decided to learn Blender, would you want me to stream the process of trying to learn Blender? I'm not promising I will stream it, because it may be more frustrating than I am willing to stream. And it will not be a tutorial to show you how, because I won't know how. I will be struggling. Blender is a 3D modeling and animation software. It is a software for 3D modeling. And it is infamous for being one of the hardest softwares to learn how to use. People literally joke, they're like, yeah, I've been using Blender consistently for about 3 years, and I am happy to report I have learned how to rotate the cube. All right, like, it is notoriously hard. Rip glyph. Good luck, have fun. I had to figure that out. I do 3D modeling all the time, though. Hit me up. Yeah, I will absolutely hit you up if I need help. But I desperately want to learn Blender. I want to learn. I don't know why. I recently saw that it, like, I was looking at it and seeing some of the things you can do, and it was like, I gotta know. Maybe I'll be good at it. Maybe I'll be absolutely awful at it, but maybe I'll get it. You, if you do 3D modeling, do you do modeling in Blender or do you use a different program? Because I know there's like a shit ton of programs that people use. Are you a Blender person? Simon's NX, I'll see you in hell. Yeah, it's... I'm excited to try and learn it. I may even like open it up tonight just to see what it looks like. And like maybe poke it for the first time and then give it like a good 24 hours where I don't touch it at all. So we'll see. Anyways, I'm going to stop yapping now and probably send you guys off. I saw some like teeny tiny art streamer over here, so I may just ship you guys over there. Maybe. Let me see. Let's see. Hang on, this titties. Take me out of titties. Less titties, please. Less titties than that, maybe? Why is everything art tibbies? Why is it live, left, love titties? Let me see if I can find, what was the game we were just playing? Indigo Park? I was gonna see if I could find that really quickly. Is anybody actually streaming it? There's one person playing it. It is not in English. Unfortunately, I will not send you guys over there. Just simply because it is not in English. Alright. Zeta, we can both learn Blender together on stream. New activity. There you go. I've used Simon's NX, Revit, Auto Inventor, AutoCAD, SolidWorks. But I thought titties paws. Titties are paws, but not usually drawing titties, because it usually feels a little sexist. Like 9 times out of 10. Like almost every time. But this is also suspicious. Everywhere I go, it's art that is not age appropriate for anything. I don't know where I am. Give me. I have no idea where you want to go. It's 12:30. Yeah, it's not surprising. It's not. It's all 8:30. It's all 18 plus. It's all 18 plus titties. It's just titties everywhere I turn. Everywhere I look, it's just titties. I can find no reprise. Please. Okay. I'm gonna do it this way. Viewers low to high. Let's find some little guys. Oh, this is all titties. Jesus Christ! I hate the may contain sexual themes. I also would love to send you guys somewhere that isn't, You look normal.
The United States was on the brink of reneging on their deal. The deal that Kennedy made with Ikeda.
Maybe not at all. You know what? I may just let you guys scatter. If I may, could you write... Yeah, sure. So, honestly, I gotta start planning things. I have people I have saved to raid. Like, I've got people. But they're all done streaming by the time... I need to start finding people on my time. On my safe side of the world. Alright, fuck it. We'll send you to Jen. Alright, we're going to Jen. I'm sending you guys out there. I need to find people who are live at the time that I end. They're playing Resident Evil. You guys go have fun. Have a great night. Take care of each other. Take care of yourselves. I'll be back on Friday. I can't promise you doing what. Anyways, smooches. Not for you, though. Not for you in particular. If you looked up when I said not for you, not for you then. But I think you know who they're for. They are for your dad. Bye.